tonight, joined by Alex Reed shortly as the Icemen will once again play the Atlanta Gladiators. Jacksonville leads this best of seven series 2-0. They have games 3 and 4 tonight and tomorrow, both here at home. So the opportunity is there for Jacksonville to potentially stay in Jacksonville this entire series and never have to go to Atlanta. This will be a big one against the Gladiators, who are playing some desperate hockey right now. Opening faceoff in just a few minutes. First, let's bring you down to ice level for the singing of your national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets ran glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the
beautiful rendition. It is hockey time in downtown Jacksonville. A big lift for the Icemen with the return of Captain Christopher Brown tonight. You may have heard his name in the starting lineups. Brown has been with the Hershey Bears of the American Hockey League for over 4 months now, but comes back tonight here in the playoffs. He will be suited up for the Icemen tonight and tomorrow night for sure. Hershey in the American Hockey League is in the playoffs, but they have an 11-day stretch without a single game. So Brown comes back to Jacksonville for at least these 2 games. Not sure if it's going to be long-term. I expect him to go back to Hershey when their playoffs begin. Hershey will have a best-of-3 series next week, and depending on how that series goes may determine whether the Icemen get Christopher Brown back, perhaps in the second round of the playoffs. But we're jumping ahead of ourselves. Let's talk about tonight first, as the Icemen lead this best of seven series 2-0. A pair of one-goal victories, one of them 3-2 in game one, the other one 5-4 in overtime. And Atlanta has played well in both of these games, but not enough to win. The Icemen have done just enough to hold them off here at home. Again, if you're new to this series, Jacksonville gets the first 4 games at home because Atlanta didn't have any ice availability at their rink. So Jacksonville catches a break there, and we are underway. Your referees tonight, and again, there's 2 of them in playoff hockey. Alex Normandin with Sam Heidemann, your linesman Tanem Wyonzik, and Antoine Bujold-Roux, as Atlanta plays the puck behind the Jacksonville net. Gladiators are first on the puck, trying to center as Waugh. Knocked free, sharp angle shot from Neely, goes off the side of the net. Centering pass, that's picked off by Fortunato. Not cleared out yet. Puck deflects into an open corner near side. The Icemen are hemmed in their own zone. Bouncing puck, Fortunato moving it for Brown. He'll turn and chip it off the boards towards the blue line. Finally, it comes out to center ice. Bouncing puck there, and Nazarian bats it into the Atlanta zone. The Gladiators get it right back out. Good step up by Fortunato. The Icemen are onside, and Nazarian couldn't set up a streaking Brendan Harris. It would have been a breakaway had Nazarian been able to get the puck to him. Atlanta now clears in. No icing here. They say that they got to center ice for Atlanta. The Icemen looking to break out of their zone. They can't do it yet. Steal from Holscher. He'll move it to the opposite side. Graves comes in from the blue line to hold it in. Mitchell Holscher, left wing faceoff circle, centering feed right through the blue paint. That was dangerous. Golfing at it is Howarchuk. Bounces up into the air, still not out yet, and the Gladiators still with it. So a good opening couple of shifts here from Atlanta. Jacksonville now breaks out of their zone. It is Harris to center ice. He'll chip it in. Howarchuk chases after it. Ben Howarchuk, the hero in game two with the overtime game winner, and the Icemen with some pressure offensively, trying to keep the puck in along the boards. Atlanta drills it off the glass and out. This will be icing. We have our first stoppage in play with 18 minutes, 18 seconds to go in period number one. It is no score between Jacksonville and Atlanta, and a critical game for the Icemen. They want to continue with the pressure here on home ice, make sure that the Gladiators don't have any thought of bringing it home to Atlanta, where they could potentially come back in this series. Jacksonville does not want to allow that. They play things right on home ice. They won't even have to go to Atlanta at all. The Icemen with Travis Howe, Ian McKinnon, and Derek Lodermeyer up front. A big, heavy line. McKinnon, an immediate shot off the draw. Chris Nell makes the save for Atlanta. Same goaltender matchup as it was for game one with these two clubs. As Sang-Hoon Shin takes the man down. Where's the penalty? Is that going to be on Atlanta? Or is it going to be on Giles? Holding is the call. And let's see who heads to the box. Was it Shin trying to hold Giles? I believe that it was. Waiting to see which penalty box door opens up. They're going to bring it into the Atlanta zone. It is a penalty on Sang-Hoon Shin. And a power play for Jacksonville, where the Icemen finally got on the board with the man advantage in the third period of game two, breaking the seal in this series as the Icemen 1-for-12 on the power play in this series. But once you get one, sometimes the floodgates open. Icemen win the draw. Martin, wrist shot. It goes over the crossbar. Comes off the glass. Atlanta tries to clear. Held in by Panetta. Great play with the second effort. Panetta leaving it to the half boards. It is Harris. Center point. Drops it to the left side. Gerdukas. Snapshot. Saved by Nell. Rebound for Nazarian. He'll rim it around, but there was nobody there. Craig Martin had pinched into the high slot, and so he will have to track it down, and the Icemen will reset. Jacob Panetta with some speed through center ice. Feeds it for Martin. He's onside. Drop pass for Nazarian. Nazarian plays it down low. Atlanta gets it. They'll rim it around to the line by Panetta and out. Foot race for the puck. Panetta trying to beat Hugo Watt to it. He does. And here comes Jacksonville through center. Gerdukas for Harris. Clean entry into the zone. Looking for Gerdukas again. He's held up on the play. And Atlanta will skate with the puck. I think the fans wanted a potential interference call on Atlanta. None forthcoming. And there's still a minute to go on this power play for Jacksonville. Brandon Fortunato now on the second power play unit. Over the blue line, the Icemen are onside. Lodermeyer shot looking for a stick for Jacob Friend. Couldn't redirect it home. Jacksonville gets it back, however. It is Friend to the left point for Fortunato. Cross ice, Christopher Brown back out onto the ice. Brown at the right faceoff circle. Saucer pass, Fortunato. Wrister deflected. Score! Luke Lynch has put the Icemen on top. 1-0 on a power play goal. Just 3:18 into the game as we bring in Alex Reed, and Jacksonville on the board early.
Power play is sizzling, Arlie. How about that? Two for the last two. How about that for Jacksonville? Able to get their last goal in regulation on the power play in game two. And then, of course, they get the first one here in regulation to start off this one on the power play. And there you go. Jacksonville working that power play. And I really like the flow and the momentum they built on that power play. Early, they were working around. They were taking shots. They were just missing on a couple of opportunities. They looked poised and calm. And then they get the tip, and they've got the lead.
Here's Joe Massa with your goal call. Steal from Jacksonville. Howe, backhander, big save by Nell. We'll come back to Joe in just a moment, but Atlanta with a turnover in their own zone. And now it's Ian McKinnon trying to keep it in. Turner just gets it away and out to center ice. Here come the Gladiators, but a poke check from Jacob Panetta. Joe, we'll get you next time because there's too much action going on here as Travis Howe nearly took the roof off of this place with a goal just seconds apart. And now it's Jacksonville skating through center again. Howe is over the blue line. playing it down low. Howell will chase after it. Tim Davison feeds it to the left for Bates. Bates gets hit into the boards by James Sanchez as he finishes his check, but Atlanta skates into the zone. Wrist shot over the crossbar, comes all the way out to center ice. Davison flipping it back, and Atlanta moves it cross ice. So a power play goal from Luke Lynch, his first, and what a redirect that was from Lynchy as well. A very tippable shot from Fortunato, but he took that out of midair, redirected it off the post and in.
Yeah, Fortunato, he'll take those shots. He'll get him to the net. May not always go in for him, but he gets him to the right areas where someone else can benefit from it, and that was the case there. And again, Lynch going to the net, being in that hard area, and he got rewarded for it with the big tally.
Jacksonville cannot clear out yet. Easy save made by Brassard. Rebound comes for the Icemen. Sanchez up the left side. Penalty on Jacksonville this time. Sean Giles is going to go to the box. Interference is going to be the call. And a power play for the Gladiators. Still not quite 5 minutes into this game, but we've got a lot of activity going on.
Yeah, special teams making its presence felt here early going. Obviously, the Icemen scoring on the power play. And now this Jacksonville penalty kill, which has been fantastic and stingy so far here in the first two games. They're a perfect 10 for 10 on the penalty kill. They'll get an opportunity right now to see their first action tonight and try to preserve the lead that they've built here early on.
Atlanta is dangerous with the man advantage. Don't let that 0 for 10 on the power play fool you. They've got weapons.
Right, and that's what's so significant about the fact that the Icemen have done so well in the penalty kill so far. This is a lethal unit out there. That first unit here for Atlanta, nothing to scoff at. This is a talented group with a lot of explosiveness.
The Icemen did get an early clear on the faceoff. Atlanta brings it back in. Fortunato defends, but Holscher works it underneath for Sangun Sheen. Sheen in the corner, all the way to the blue line. Good look for Davison. Wrist shot. Save made by Brassard. Got it with a paddle of his stick, but it knocked his stick off of his hands. Atlanta gets the puck, and Brassard does not have his stick right now. Slap shot from Davison. That goes wide. Redirects to the far side wall. Gertler holds it in. Dangerous moment here for Jacksonville. They need a clear. Fortunato, great hustle there to work into the corner and get the stick back to Francois Brassard. That's a heady play. Atlanta still has the puck in the zone, but at least Brassard now has his stick. It's Davison, cross ice, right circle. Stepping around a man is Holscher. Looks to center, knocked away by Jacksonville. Taken back by Holscher. Friend gets a piece of the puck, but he can't play it either. Comes behind the net. Jacksonville, can they get the clear away? No, Holscher with a centering feed. Stolen by Lynch. Off the glass to the blue line, not out. Great play by Davison. Right side of the Sheen, playing it down low. Gertler can't center, it was knocked away. Gladiators get it back. The puck has been in the zone for over a minute straight here. 35 seconds to go. Brassard with a save. No rebound on the wrister from the blue line.
Boy, oh boy, did Atlanta miss Tim Davison, huh? I mean, he's already being very active there on this power play. Took three shots there, got two of them through, and he's a welcome sight. He's been out of the lineup for last several weeks due to an injury, so Jeff Pyle's got to be thrilled about that. What I saw there a little bit, though, early in the penalty kill side of it, the Icemen having a tough time on those clears. That's something that's been plaguing them, not only really in power play and penalty kill situations, but really when they're hemmed down and the pressure's on by Atlanta offensively, the Icemen have had a tough time getting the puck out sometimes.
That's partially Jacksonville just not doing what it takes, but it's also part Atlanta's forecheck, which is exceptional, among the best, at least in the South Division. Gladiators with the puck again in the offensive zone. It is Sylvester into the bumper for Neely. Neely cannot center, was deflected behind the net. Neely gets it back. He'll play it to the corner for Nesbitt. Nesbitt for Cody Sylvester. You see those two guys on the second power play unit?
Right.
It'll give you an idea of just how potent this club is offensively. Jacksonville gets a steal. Clearing it out is Panetta. And out of the penalty box is Sean Giles. Team skate at 5-on-5. And the Icemen now 11 for 11 on the penalty kill in the postseason. It's Brassard playing it behind his net for Zach Berzola. Up the right side, Martin can't handle it. It deflects out to the Atlanta blue line. Campbell on the left, chips it away from one man, but he gives it up to the Icemen and Zach Berzola. Berzola for Christopher Brown, who assisted in the early minutes of his return to Jacksonville. We have an offside call against Jacksonville, but Christopher Brown already making an impact for Jacksonville. An assist on Luke Lynch's power play goal has the Icemen on top by a score of 1-0 with 12:38 to go in period number one. This is game three of the Kelly Cup semifinals in the South Division. This is Jacksonville Icemen hockey on flowhockey.tv and on Mixlr.
Tonight's game is brought to you by the ECHL, celebrating its 34th season of affordable family entertainment. The ECHL would like to recognize the following league sponsors: AMI Graphics, official signage provider; Athletic Knit, official jersey supplier; Baron Rings, official championship ring supplier; BFL Canada Insurance and Sutton Special Risk, sponsors of the 2022 ECHL Hall of Fame induction ceremony; Flow Sports, the exclusive streaming provider of the ECHL; Geico, official auto insurance of the ECHL; The Fairley Group, official commercial insurance provider; Handbid, the official mobile auction app; Honigs, the official partner of the ECHL officiating team; Howie's Hockey Tape, official hockey tape and lace provider; In Glasgow, official puck provider; Migre Group, your source for game-worn jerseys; Sideline Swap, official online marketplace of the ECHL; and Warrior, exclusive on-ice equipment provider of the ECHL and title sponsor of the 2022 ECHL All-Star Classic. Catch all of the ECHL action live in high definition by logging on to flowhockey.tv.
We are back. Jacksonville on top, 1-0. They have it at center ice. Skating with it is Abbott Gerdukas. He'll get to the red line and rim it around. Nell will block it behind his net for Tim Davison. So the Icemen get one man back in Christopher Brown, but Atlanta did as well. You already addressed it, Reader, with the return of Tim Davison from injury for Atlanta.
Yeah, they've missed him, and there's no doubt about it. That was a big loss for them here in the last couple of weeks of the regular season and obviously the first couple of games in the postseason. But he's back and making his presence felt right off the get-go.
Icemen onside. Crowd wants a delay. All right, sick, too many men on the ice penalty. Instead, it's the Icemen into the zone. Berzola couldn't quite get around a man. Comes back to the blue line, held in by Jacksonville. Batting at the puck is Atlanta. They will keep possession. Hounding a man is Nazarian. Penalty coming on Nazarian. He hates this call. He went straight to the referee about it. Alex Normandin. Crowd in a chorus of boos right now.
Yeah, I thought he was making a good play on the puck that time. I'd like to see another look at it there to see, you know, what the situation was. But he was going all puck there. Didn't really play much of the body. But again, you are responsible for your stick. We'll see this angle right here. He was just going hard for the puck. He had a piece of it there. Yeah, there was a little bit of contact there on the leg as the Atlanta defender was trying to go in after it there. And so I could see the call.
The Atlanta defender sold it, I will say that, but that doesn't mean that it wasn't a hook either.
Correct. Yeah, he went down like a ton of bricks, but again, there was some stick-on-leg situation there, and that's going to get the call, especially when the official had a good sight of it.
Back to the penalty kill for Jacksonville. Atlanta wins the faceoff in the offensive zone. It's Waugh for Sylvester, tapped by Berzola. Can he get it? No, not quite. Centering feed goes by everybody towards the blue line, held in by Topadish. Near side half boards, it's Hugo Waugh, defended by Martin. Panetta gets a piece of it with the stick. It ends up behind the net, loose there for the Gladiators. Sylvester, right wing circle, defended by Zach Berzola. All the way to the blue line. Topadish on the good look. Wrister and a screen. It goes wide. Comes off the glass. It stays in play. Lynch gets a piece of it. Centering feed goes off a skate towards the blue line. Again held in by the Gladiators. Waugh gives it up. Jacksonville with a steal. Panetta tries to clear it out. Couldn't do it. That's a gig. Again, just like what you said in the first penalty kill, Reader. An opportunity to clear that they could not get. Now they get it. And making no mistake is Craig Martin.
Yeah, it's just been a little bit of an area where, you know, they've had some difficulty. And again, you talked about the forecheck, the aggressiveness of Atlanta in those situations. When the pressure's on, they're really good at turning up the heat there, and it's really given the Icemen fits in this series. Good clear that time, though.
Atlanta brings it right back in. Still 46 seconds to go on the power play. Gladiators behind the Icemen net, flipping it to the blue line for Davison. Davison fakes the shot. He'll move it for Gertler. Playing it down low. It is Holscher. To the right wing circle, cross ice, Davison, Wrister goes just wide. Didn't miss by more than an inch or two, but fortunately comes off the kick plates hot and makes its way all the way back to the Atlanta blue line. Gladiators redirect right back in. Still 20 seconds to go on the power play. Fortunato for the Icemen, again can't clear it. Loose puck, knocked ahead from the Jacksonville. 3-on-1 shorthanded for the Icemen. It's Lodermeyer giving it up. What a play by Davison to break up that 3-and-1, and maybe that's a little bit of some lack of chemistry with Christopher Brown coming back, and he just hasn't seen these guys for quite a long time.
Yeah, that was a difficult one there for the Icemen to swallow. Didn't even get the shot off. They had a 3-on-1, and I guess that's the other thing Davison brings to the table. Oh, yeah, defensive side of it. Yeah, he has 40 points during the year and then made a great defensive play on a 3-on-1. Again, he was an all-star guy we saw here in January for the All-Star Classic, having a phenomenal season. He and Topadish both.
We'll keep it here right now with 9:35 on the clock in period number one. The Icemen are on top early, 1-0. And if nothing else, you'd just like to see them at least get a chance towards goal there.
Yeah.
I think the pass maybe came a little too early from Brown. I think he had the idea of maybe a quick give and go, maybe a one-touch pass.
Right.
But as soon as the first pass was made, I think it was Lodermeyer who kind of held onto the puck a little too long from that point and just didn't materialize the way they wanted it.
No, it didn't. You're right. There was a lot of space, a lot of room. I mean, honestly, Brown could have walked that thing down there and then made a last-second pass there. Again, you can break it down either way, too. And you could talk about maybe not, you know, you only had a morning skate with these guys to kind of get that chemistry back. But the other thing, too, Arlie, you know, Christopher Brown hasn't played a ton up in Hershey either.
No.
I think he's only got, like, five games really here in the last, you know, maybe 4 weeks or so. So he hasn't really played a ton either. So he's got to kind of get his feet back here as well. And it's part of the reason why he's here right now.
Well, he has already contributed in this one. An assist on the Luke Lynch goal, which is a textbook deflection in front. And the Icemen on top, 1-0. A couple of keys to the game, in my mind anyway, going into it, was start on time, and Jacksonville has definitely done that. The second key we won't see for a while, and that's perform better in the final 10 minutes of regulation, because the Icemen were definitely outplayed by Atlanta, truth be told, in the last 10 minutes of both games one and two. Jacksonville into the zone, it's Brown, cross ice look. I think it went off a skate and ended up going behind his intended target, which was Jacob Panetta. Comes back for Atlanta. Shot towards goal by Sheen. That goes wide. Ends up behind the net for Gerdukas. Gerdukas with one hand on the stick. Nazarian can't clear it away. Tied up along the wall. Nazarian pries it loose. And he'll move it cross ice for Panetta. Panetta forced to just shovel it into the Gladiator zone. Too soft for icing. And Atlanta moves it up ice. A deflection up into the crowd, into the first row. Everybody's okay there. Pretty soft deflection and a souvenir in row number one. With 8:37 on the clock in the first period. And it appears, Reader, and you know what, going into the series, I thought this was gonna be a series where Jacksonville would want as few power plays as possible, combined. Just not have specialty teams in general play a role, but they really have. There have been a ton of power play chances for both clubs. We're seeing it again tonight. Penalties across the league in the playoffs have really gone up with the two referee system.
Yeah, and they're able to catch a lot more. And it's kind of, you know, I wonder if they do a study on it, let you know that how much they miss maybe during the regular season, you know, by only having the one ref system. And they get it, and that's the way it is. But you're right here, Arlie. Again, it's they're able to see more of the ice, more situations. And it's not really surprising to see that the numbers have gone up.
Yeah, and, you know, give credit to Jacksonville, where the power play now has woken up, sizzling, as you called it.
Yeah.
So for the series, if you include tonight with already three power play chances, two for Atlanta and one for Jacksonville. So now you can put the Icemen at 2-for-13 on the power play and Atlanta at 0-for-12. So we thought that if Jacksonville could just neutralize the special teams in this series, that they would come away winning the series. Turns out Jacksonville is actually outperforming Atlanta in specialty teams thus far.
Yeah, at least here in this, you know, early going of the series, and you're right, they've done a good job managing it. And you know, you said just kind of limiting the opportunities and just containing, I think was that word, like you said, and they've done that.
Howe with a shot towards goal. It goes off the side of the net. He didn't miss that one by much.
He did not. A sneaky little shot that just kind of clipped up in on the high part. But there was some space there early, and that hits on the other side of the post. That's in.
An icing call against Jacksonville. Didn't expect the shot. I didn't expect the shot either, because Howe actually had a man on him. There was a puck. It was nothing more than a clearing off the boards.
Yeah.
It looked like it was just going to be a puck battle in the corner. Howe not only won the puck battle, but he was able to drive it immediately on a one-timer towards net, even though an Atlanta player was right on his shoulder.
Yeah, no, you're right. That was a great shot by Travis Howe, and it's just remarkable what he has developed into this season for this club. You know, he's not a one-dimensional guy any longer. So some people might have said that about him, but, you know, I think he gives a testament to this coaching staff for giving him the opportunity and believing in him that he can be an every shift guy here, or, you know, a normal rotation shift guy.
And I would feel similarly about Ian McKinnon, two
yes.
similar style players, and I think they're both playing at their absolute maximum amount of confidence right now. Each of them with a goal in the playoffs as well. McKinnon in game one, Howe in game two. 1-0 Jacksonville is your score. The Icemen have the puck in their own zone. We skate 5-on-5 for the moment with 7:09 remaining in the first period. Icemen deflect in behind the Atlanta net. It's Davison stepping around Howarchuk. He'll feed the boards right side. Atlanta breaks out, knocking it to an open wing. Davison now activates from the blue line to start this rush. Neely from the blue line gives it up to Jacksonville. Looking for the lead pass ahead. It comes to Sanchez. Sanchez on the right wing. He's onside. Throws it in front. Deflection in front, and a save is made by Nell. It was Giles activating from the blue line. That was a deft little deflection for a forward, let alone a stay-at-home defenseman to make that kind of deflection.
Yeah, and there's Sanchez covering for Giles there on the other direction when Atlanta brings it in. But that was a good awareness by Sanchez to see Giles crash towards the net and just kind of feathered it right there in front to allow him for that redirect chance. Simple play, seemed kind of innocent. I guarantee for Nell, that was a little bit challenging and a good chance there for Jacksonville.
It was a tester to be sure, and you mentioned that Sanchez was there covering for Giles on the backside, making a back check. Ultimately, he iced the puck, but I don't mind that because that tells me the buy-in that the Icemen players have for every little detail to see James Sanchez cover for his man there. If he doesn't do that, that could be an entirely different situation, and you're looking at an opportunity there for the Gladiators. And you need it from everybody. It can't just be a handful of them. And right now, Nick Lucco and Brandon Machinter are getting the most out of their players in every little detail as Francois Brassard makes a routine save. He'll take the faceoff. Shots on net in the early going, 4 for each club. But again, the Icemen on the heels of their one and only power play chance of the night have the lead. Luke Lynch with his first of the postseason from Brandon Fortunato and Christopher Brown. The Icemen, I should mention, going with a unique format alignment with their roster. 16 skaters and 2 goaltenders, 90% of the time, maybe more, maybe closer to 95 or the upper 90% of the time, you're gonna have 10 forwards and 6 defensemen. Well, not tonight.
No.
Beat the return of Christopher Brown, the Icemen going with 11 forwards, only 5 defensemen. Very curious to see how that plays out tonight, Reader.
Yeah, we're going to find out here. Obviously, the coaching staff confident in that decision here, but does kind of allow you, in a way, just rotating one guy in. You can kind of almost roll 4 lines, and that could really help the team down the stretch here as long as you're confident that your defensive unit can hold up there from a stamina standpoint. So we'll see how it plays out as the game lingers on.
Well, and speaking of the stamina part of it from the defensive alignment, I actually had that exact conversation with Nick Lucco about it. You know, are the guys on defense ready to go with just a group of 5? And first thing that him and assistant coach Brandon Machinger said was, as we get a wrist shot away from Jacksonville, save made by Nell on the wrister from Jacob Friend. But just to complete the thought was Jacob Panetta and Brandon Fortunato, they feel like they're Energizer bunnies. You know, they're capable of upper 20 minutes, 30 minutes possibly even. The way they said it, those guys just don't get tired. And if they're not going to get tired, we can continue to rely on them throughout the remainder of the contest. I'm curious if it makes its way to overtime, but you don't want to play as if you're going to have an overtime game, play to win in 60.
Well, just an extension. You're absolutely right, and it's great that you can have players that can contribute that way. I mean, that's going to bode well. And, you know, it's interesting. You had a chat with, you know, Nick Lucco about that. And just before I made it upstairs, the coaches, where they took the bench, you know, they were talking about that game in Norfolk in January, you know, where they had to play with 13 skaters and then end up losing Jacob Friend to a penalty, and they had 12 skaters.
Yeah.
And Brandon Machinter asked Kyle McKenzie, who's also kind of serving kind of in a coach's role now, basically said, hey, what did you think of that when you played in that game? Did you like when you just had 4D? And he actually said, yeah, actually, I felt like I got in a groove. I really liked it, you know, and so he didn't seem to mind it as much. Now they're going to have 5. So, I mean, again, it's something that, from that perspective, interesting to hear a player's perspective say that even though he was dealing with 4, having to be in a part of a two defensive pairing rotation, he said he didn't really see too much of it that was you know, going to be anything that was going to be harmful.
Well, let's see how it develops. It's a long game. Right now it's Atlanta with a shot towards goal, blocked in front. Rolls to the blue line, held in by Jacob Graves. Graves at the left side, shot towards net, deflected behind the net by Howe. Gladiators with it. They've put a little pressure on Jacksonville here. They've probably had the territorial edge in play. It's looking at getting a wraparound attempt as Gertler. Broussard is there for the save. At the blue line, Graves just holds it in. Fortunato chips it ahead. Howe knocks it free. Harris gets tripped up as the Icemen play it ahead. Breakaway Harris. Harris, forehand. Oh, what a save Nell with the glove keeps the Gladiators within striking distance, down just by one. Brendan Harris, who already has 3 goals this postseason, nearly got his 4th. Credit that big save from Chris Nell.
Yeah, that was just Harris. Good job there. Again, we talked about awareness, and he saw that puck kind of flutter up here, but he had all the space in the world and was able to take off the other way. He just didn't stop. He just kept his feet moving, and that propelled him to that breakaway chance there. Hats off to Nell. That was a big-time save in a big way there for his club. And you're right, heading into today, 5 points and 2 goals so far for the Iceman forward in Brendan Harris.
Nell makes another save on a wrister from the blue line.
3 goals, sorry.
Yeah, 3 goals, 2 assists for him. Icemen continue the pressure, though. It is Lodermeyer into the bumper. Lynch had his shot blocked. Couldn't pull the trigger on the one-timer. He had to get a second attempt at it, and Atlanta was there defensively. Now they clear it out. The Icemen from center ice. It's McKinnon from the red line. He'll wrist it in cross corner. Lodermeyer gives chase against Davison. Davison sidesteps the hit from Lodermeyer as Atlanta clears out. Will this be icing? Yes, it will. And the draw comes into the Atlanta zone with 4:08 to go. Going back to that breakaway from Harris, you know he wanted to try and go top shelf over that glove.
Yeah.
Didn't quite go top shelf. It was maybe about halfway up the net, maybe about 3 feet high. If he had gotten it about 4 feet high, different story.
Yeah, exactly. And, and hats off Nell. He never really budged, never really panicked. Had that poise there, and that was a tough shot. I mean, he caught it cleanly. There was like it just rattled in and out or bounced off the glove. That was a smooth catch there into the mid.
What a play by Sanchez to keep that puck into the zone and keep it onside. He had to be very patient, and the Icemen have the puck at the blue line now. It's Nazarian sidestepping a man. Nazarian on his backhand works it towards the goal. It is blocked and cleared by the Gladiators. Really like the game and James Sanchez these last couple of nights also. Peaking at the right time. You need to do it as a team, and you need to have a bunch of individuals doing the same thing. Puck goes off a linesman right to the Gladiators. Man, did that work out well in their favor. Atlanta takes it into the zone because of it. Sylvester, turnaround shot, blocked in front. Sylvester gets it right back. Dalton thrower, cross ice for Bernard. Bernard, a shot intentionally wide off the boards, comes off the wall for the Icemen. It is Sanchez to the left for Howarchuk, who tries to backhand it out, but it ends up going into the bench instead. And the faceoff will come to the Iceman zone with 3:12 to go in period number one. Jacksonville on top, 1-0. And coming up in the first intermission, Reader, go through the remainder of this series schedule. What will definitely be played? What are the if necessary games? And we'll also take you around the league. There's 5 games on tap around the league, including the other game in the South Division with Florida visiting at Greenville tonight.
Yeah, that series tied at 1. Florida had a rally from a 3-goal deficit to win that game. So they're going to be without their captain, John McCarron, for the next 2 games of that series, suspended for a kneeing call.
Yeah,
we'll
talk about that probably
too. Yeah.
Forgot about that. That could be very impactful on that series. We'll save that one for the intermission and how it affects Florida and Greenville and potentially the winner of this series here, too.
Yeah, I'd consider John McCarron an impact player.
I would, yeah.
That's a significant loss there for a couple of games, especially in a tie series like that. I think you and I both said it was going to go 7.
Well, Greenville.
See if it happens.
Yeah, Greenville will have the door open to maybe do a little damage on home ice as the Icemen get the puck out of the zone. Then a steal from Craig Martin. He'll take it into the Atlanta end. Drop pass for Brown. Wrister goes off the side of the net. Martin tries the bank shot. Collision at the short side post. And Atlanta clears it away, at least towards the corner. But the Icemen get it right back. Into the bumper. Martin couldn't get the shot away. Comes back to Atlanta. They'll clear it out. Comes to center ice, and the Icemen regroup with it. Trying to catch Atlanta in a line change. It's Gerdukas over the blue line. Martin at the right circle. Into the centering feed. What a move by Howe. Backhander on net. Save made by Nell. A beauty of an effort there from Travis Howe. Atlanta now in the other direction. Sheen with a shot right into the midsection of Brassard. He'll take the face off. Travis Howe.
Dangles for days.
Yes.
What a move by Howe to collect that puck in the slot on his forehand, deep to the backhand, go around the defender and get himself an opportunity and another challenging save. Forced that time for Nell.
Faceoff will be to the left of Brassard. 2:09 to go. I mean, all these little things, even if they're not resulting in goals necessarily, just continues to build the confidence of the team and the individuals around it. I mean, how does Travis Howe feel right now? Sure, he didn't score, but he's like, guys, you see that move? I'm sure they're going to talk about it in the locker room. And it's going to make everybody feel great about it. Just need to continue to carry it over as the Icemen carry the puck out of their own zone right off the draw. McKinnon, he was trying to dangle too, but he couldn't get around Davison that time. Atlanta clears in. Berzola into the corner, a turnover there. Atlanta holds in. Bernard at the right point. To the boards for Gertler and behind the net, Atlanta. Berzola rubs a man out, comes free for Lodermeyer, chipping it off the wall for McKinnon. He'll skate with Luke Lynch and with Panetta activating. Lynch from center ice, a simple chip into the zone, chasing after the on the forecheck is Brendan Harris. Atlanta, however, will work it free and out to the Jacksonville line. Fortunato plays it to the neutral zone. He gets it right back to the left wing. It is Howerchuk. Howerchuk for Martin. Caught him in stride. Martin tripped up. Penalty coming on Atlanta. Delayed call. Martin now gives it up. Atlanta gets the touch. And there is your penalty call with 1:11 to go. Because that pass was perfectly in stride to Craig Martin, that's what created that penalty.
It was. And again, that's just, you know, basic execution and little details in the game there. But you're right. You know, that was a perfect play. He was going to have a chance in on Nell until the penalty was committed. And, of course, it was called. And now another power play for that sizzling Jacksonville power play.
The Icemen will start with Abbott Gerdukas, Brendan Harris, Aaron Azarian up front. At the point, it's Jacob Panetta along with Craig Martin as your fourth forward. Gerdukas trying to win the draw to Martin at the right point along the glass. Instead, it is Atlanta. They'll turn and fire. It's held in. Martin gloves it down to his stick. Cross ice for Panetta. Panetta, center point. Dishes to the left for Gerdukas. He's at the top of the circle. Panetta cannot get the one-timer away. Feeding it for Gerdukas. Panetta now he gets the one-timer. Save is made. Rebound for Gerdukas. Back to the line for Panetta. Martin at the right circle. Panetta gets it back. Panetta holds. Gerdukas at the circle again. Good-looking power play. Gerdukas takes the shot. Saved by Nell. Rebound for Harris. Back to the blue line for Gerdukas at the left point. Panetta, 55 feet away. To the right circle. It is Martin. Great-looking power play here. Here's Panetta. One-timer. Blocked in front. Comes back to Martin. Cross ice for Gerdukas. Neely caught that one up high, but he is okay. Martin, one-timer. Saved by Nell. Rebound for Atlanta. They'll try the opposite wing, but the Icemen continue with it. It is Harris. Stepping away from a man, feeding it into the corner. Gerdukas behind the net, tries to find a centering pass. Shot on goal, towards goal anyway, deflected away. Icemen get it back. What a power play. Panetta fakes the shot. Shot towards goal, deflected and a save by Nell. Rebound behind the net, and time will expire in the period. Couldn't ask for a better power play there from Jacksonville. They are feeling great about their game just in general, and now they're feeling great about things with the man advantage too.
Yeah, I think so. Saved by the bell were the Gladiators there, Arlie. They were under siege, and that horn couldn't have come any quicker for them. And Jacksonville, again, what a great-looking power play. They're doing it with confidence, moving the puck around efficiently, effectively. They're opening up lanes and taking shots, and that was a great period of hockey. 13-7, the shots on goal tabulation here in favor of Jacksonville. But really love the power play, Arlie, and
yeah.
I love the tempo. I think Jacksonville, you know, heading into this game, they had that challenge of having to deal with an Atlanta club who was going to be playing probably a little desperate here, knowing the magnitude of this game and which way it swings. And I thought the Icemen handled themselves brilliantly in that first period.
I'm glad you said that, because looking at the first 20 minutes, Jacksonville played like the more desperate team than Atlanta. That's
yeah.
a great sign. You want to play desperate hockey no matter where you are in a playoff series.
Absolutely.
And I think the Icemen look at this as if it's desperation time, because they don't want to give Atlanta a breath of life thinking that they can take this series back home for potentially the final three games of the series. So great observation, and I think Jacksonville is the one playing as the more desperate team. I will say, credit Chris Nell with that opportunity and playing some big-time goaltending for Atlanta in the final minute there, because all those shots on goal from Jacksonville really helping out creating the momentum, but Chris Nell was their best penalty killer. We'll go to break right now. We'll come back in a little bit. After one period of play, it is Jacksonville 1, Atlanta nothing. Power play goal from Luke Lynch, just 3:18 into the game, has the Icemen on top. Brandon Fortunato and Christopher Brown in his return to Jacksonville after a four-month absence in the American Hockey League. That's where Jacksonville stands on top, 1-0. We will take a break and return shortly. This is Jacksonville Icemen Hockey.
Tonight's game is brought to you by the ECHL, celebrating its 34th season of affordable family entertainment. The ECHL would like to recognize the following league sponsors: AMI Graphics, official signage provider; Athletic Knit, official jersey supplier; Baron Rings, official championship ring supplier; BFL Canada Insurance and Sutton Special Risk, sponsors of the 2022 ECHL Hall of Fame induction ceremony; Flow Sports, the exclusive streaming provider of the ECHL; Geico, official auto insurance of the ECHL; The Fairley Group, official commercial insurance provider; Handbid, the official mobile auction app; Honigs, the official partner of the ECHL officiating team; Howie's Hockey Tape, official hockey tape and lace provider; In Glasgow, official puck provider; Migre Group, your source for game-worn jerseys; Sideline Swap, official online marketplace of the ECHL; and Warrior, exclusive on-ice equipment provider of the ECHL and title sponsor of the 2022 ECHL All-Star Classic. Catch all of the ECHL action live in high definition by logging on to flowhockey.tv.
Don't forget, this game is being streamed live around the world today. Go to flowhockey.tv to catch all of the Icemen action and archived footage of the event. Flow Hockey is the live streaming home for the Icemen. Get the Flow Sports iOS and Android apps to watch the event live and on the go. Upgrade to a pro subscription and you can gain access to premium content on all Flow Sports sites. This includes more than 1,000 live events, original documentaries, exclusive training and technique videos, and much more. Follow Flow Hockey on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube to get the latest news and updates from the Icemen and other upcoming Flow Hockey events. FlowHockey.tv, the new streaming home of the Jacksonville Icemen and the ECHL.
Just be positive. Your community first mortgage champions make sure you get a great rate, a quick close, and can save you about $3,000 in closing costs. Apply at communityfirstfl.org. Community First Credit Union. Just be yourself. Federally insured by NCUA. Equal housing lender.
The Jacksonville Icemen offer discounted tickets for groups of 10 or more. Whether it's a company outing, a group from your school or church, or just a gathering of friends, the Icemen can help you set up a night of fun at a discounted cost. Other benefits include an intermission ride on the popular FanZam, a post-game group photo, or take a shot on net after the game. Ticket fundraisers are also available. For more information, contact the Icemen office at 904-602-PUCK. That's 904-602-7825, or visit us online at jacksicemen.com. Icemen Hockey, feel the freeze.
Best Bet Jacksonville and Orange Park are open and excited to bring you the best in poker, simulcast wagering, cocktails, sushi, and more. Visit bestbetjacks.com for more information. Best Bet, experience the best.
The Jacksonville Icemen are always looking to give back to the communities of North Florida. The team offers a ticket fundraising program that many local nonprofits and schools and charitable organizations can take advantage of. The program is simple. Your organization sells tickets to an Icemen home game, and a portion of each ticket purchase will go directly to your cause. This is a fun and easy way to raise money and gain exposure for your organization or school. For more information, contact the Icemen office at 904-602-PUCK. That's 904-602-7825, or log on to jacksicemen.com.
Just be in control. With free interest checking and great digital tools, Community First makes smarter banking simple. Add an account at justbeyourself.com. Community First Credit Union. Just be yourself. Federally insured by NCUA.
NHL players have amazing talent, and some of the very best developed right here in the ECHL.
Beagles in, he scores!
Now, follow all your favorite ECHL alumni every night on NHL Network's primetime hockey show, NHL Tonight.
Both teams recognize how big this matchup is.
Fire save by Dubin. Rebound!
Goosebumps stuff.
NHL Tonight, every night 6 Eastern on NHL Network.
Hi, everyone. This is Allie McDeal from the Best Bet Poker Rooms. Experience the popular Vegas-style game Fortune Pigao Poker. Both locations are now playing face-up Pigao. It's more fun to play than ever. You could win up to $25,000 on a single $5 bet. Come play at either Best Bet location today.
What is your role in the fight against cancer? The answer could be as simple as driving your car. For many cancer patients, getting to and from treatment is one of their toughest challenges. The American Cancer Society needs volunteer drivers to help provide transportation for people in your community. Through the gift of a lift in your car, you can help patients take one more step in the road to recovery. Get in the driver's seat in the fight against cancer. To find out more, call your American Cancer Society at 1-800-227-2345 or visit cancer.org.
If you feel that passion is just the start, if you think practice is never over, if you believe speed limits are just for highways and Saturday mornings aren't made for cartoons, if you try, fail, learn, laugh, repeat, compete, respect, and unite, then you belong on our team. Join now at team.ccmhockey.com.
Just be confident. Community First makes smarter banking simple so you can relax, knowing you're managing your money the right way, yours. Visit justbeyourself.com. Community First Credit Union. Just be yourself. Federally insured by NCUA.
Through one period of play, the Jacksonville Icemen have a 1-0 lead over the Atlanta Gladiators. I don't think that even tells the story. Jacksonville out shooting the Gladiators 13-7 in the first period of play. Peppering the net of Chris Nell. I think without Chris Nell, he was Atlanta's best player in that first period. It could easily be 2 or 3-0 after one period of play. And I love our conversation between Alex Reed and myself when we were going into the break that Jacksonville is just flat out playing like they're the more desperate team, even though the Icemen are the club that is leading this series 2-0. I expected this kind of desperation from Atlanta. And right now, I know there's 40 minutes left, and Atlanta has played better as each game has gone along. They've been more a finisher than an opener. And so you certainly have plenty of work to do, but Atlanta did not come out firing the way that their head coach, Jeff Pyle, certainly would have wanted them to. Whereas for Jacksonville and their coaching staff, they've got to be thrilled with the opening 20 minutes of play. Let's go now to the upcoming schedule for the Jacksonville Icemen in this series. We can really only talk about this series for the time being. Jacksonville, of course, up 2-0, and with the unique format because Atlanta didn't have their ice available. Remember, the Gladiators were supposed to have home ice in this series, but because they have Disney on ice in their building, they were forced to give the first 4 games of the series to Jacksonville, and the Icemen are taking advantage. So game 3, obviously, tonight. The Icemen looking for a commanding 3-0 series lead if they can win it tonight. Game 4, right back here in Jacksonville tomorrow. But that's the final home game of this series for the Icemen against Atlanta. No matter what, whether they win or lose, that's going to be it. So Jacksonville wants to win these 2 tonight and tomorrow. If they can do that, they do not even have to travel to Atlanta. And what a benefit that would be for Jacksonville from a rest standpoint, from a confidence standpoint. It would do a world of good, even from a financial standpoint, for that matter, just not getting the guys up and running for the weekend. But if Atlanta is able to get a victory either tonight or tomorrow, they would force a game 5, and that would go to Atlanta. Games 5, 6, and 7, all of those games are if necessary, but if they are necessary, they would all be played in Atlanta. So if the Gladiators get even 1 win, they're gonna go home feeling, okay, well, we're down, but we've got our home ice. All we have to do is take care of business at home. It would give them a bit of a lift, I guess is the point behind it, and Jacksonville does not want to allow even that lift to take place for the Gladiators. Let's set it up, though, just in case. All these games, if necessary, in Atlanta. Game 5 would be played Sunday at 3 o'clock. Game 6, if necessary, Monday at 7 o'clock. And Game 7, if necessary, would be Jacksonville at Atlanta on Wednesday, May the 4th. So that is your upcoming schedule for the Icemen. We will take a break and return in a moment. We'll give you an update around the ECHL scoreboard in Round 1 of the Kelly Cup playoffs. It's Jacksonville leading this one. 1-0 is your score after one period of play. This is Jacksonville Icemen Hockey.
Don't forget, this game is being streamed live around the world today. Go to flowhockey.tv to catch all of the Icemen action and archived footage of the event. Flow Hockey is the live streaming home for the Icemen. Get the Flow Sports iOS and Android apps to watch the event live and on the go. Upgrade to a pro subscription, and you can gain access to premium content on all Flow Sports sites. This includes more than 1,000 live events, original documentaries, exclusive training, and technique videos, and much more. Follow Flow Hockey on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube to get the latest news and updates from the Icemen and other upcoming Flow Hockey events. FlowHockey.tv, the new streaming home of the Jacksonville Icemen and the ECHL.
Just be positive. Your Community First Mortgage champions make sure you get a great rate, a quick close, and can save you about $3,000 in closing costs. Apply at CommunityFirstFL.org. Community First Credit Union. Just be yourself. Federally insured by NCUA. Equal housing lender.
The Jacksonville Icemen offer discounted tickets for groups of 10 or more. Whether it's a company outing, a group from your school or church, or just a gathering of friends, the Icemen can help you set up a night of fun at a discounted cost. Other benefits include an intermission ride on the popular FanZam, a post-game group photo, or take a shot on net after the game. Ticket fundraisers are also available. For more information, contact the Icemen office at 904-602-PUCK. That's 904-602-7825, or visit us online at jacksicemen.com. Icemen Hockey, feel the freeze.
Best Bet Jacksonville and Orange Park are open and excited to bring you the best in poker, simulcast wagering, cocktails, sushi, and more. Visit bestbetjacks.com for more information. Best Bet, experience the best.
The Jacksonville Icemen are always looking to give back to the communities of North Florida. The team offers a ticket fundraising program that many local nonprofits and schools and charitable organizations can take advantage of. The program is simple. Your organization sells tickets to an Icemen home game, and a portion of each ticket purchase will go directly to your cause. This is a fun and easy way to raise money and gain exposure for your organization or school. For more information, contact the Icemen office at 904-602-PUCK. That's 904-602-7825, or log on to jacksicemen.com.
Just be in control. With free interest checking and great digital tools, Community First makes smarter banking simple. Add an account at justbeyourself.com. Community First Credit Union. Just be yourself. Federally insured by NCUA.
NHL players have amazing talent and some of the very best developed right here in the ECHL.
Beagles in, he scores!
Now, follow all your favorite ECHL alumni every night on NHL Network's primetime hockey show, NHL Tonight.
Both teams recognize how big this matchup is.
Fire save by Dubin, rebound!
Goosebump stuff.
NHL Tonight, every night 6 Eastern on NHL Network.
Hi, everyone. This is Allie McDeal from the Best Bet Poker Rooms. Experience the popular Vegas-style game Fortune Pie-Gal Poker. Both locations are now playing face-up Pie-Gal. It's more fun to play than ever. You could win up to $25,000 on a single $5 bet. Come play at either Best Bet location today.
What is your role in the fight against cancer? The answer could be as simple as driving your car. For many cancer patients, getting to and from treatment is one of their toughest challenges. The American Cancer Society needs volunteer drivers to help provide transportation for people in your community. Through the gift of a lift in your car, you can help patients take one more step in the road to recovery. Get in the driver's seat in the fight against cancer. To find out more, call your American Cancer Society at 1-800-227-2345 or visit cancer.org.
If you feel that passion is just the start, if you think practice is never over, if you believe speed limits are just for highways and Saturday mornings aren't made for cartoons, if you try, fail, learn, laugh, repeat, compete, respect, and unite, then you belong on our team. Join now at team.ccmhockey.com.
We are back in downtown Jacksonville. Arlie Johnson with you, along with Alex Reed. The Icemen on top, 1-0. They also are on a power play when the second period begins for another 50 seconds. That second power play, which they did not score on in the final minute, ended up being phenomenal. And the Icemen, of course, scored early in the game, also on a power play. And Reeder, specialty teams a factor in the opening 20 here.
Yeah, they really were. And, you know, especially for the Jacksonville Icemen now, they've got back-to-back. They've got back-to-back power plays that they were able to score on. I'm talking about the last power play that they had in game two.
Right.
They scored a power play goal. Then they come in today, get the first one, score another one. And that's how you build momentum. That's how you build confidence. And here on the current one, right before the end of the first period, the second one they got here, I thought they were going to score again. Yes. The way they were working around and getting shots, they still have 50 seconds on that opportunity. But this is a situation where, you know, it just seems like the team's playing with a little confidence on the power play. And this is a group that finished 26th out of the 27 teams with the man advantage. So that bodes well if they can build some momentum. That's really going to propel this team the rest of the way out.
Even if the Icemen end up not scoring in these next 50 seconds,
correct,
they're still going to feel great about how effective this power play was. And just, okay, we didn't get it this time, credit their goaltender, on to the next one, assuming that they get another power play opportunity in this game. Quickly, let's go to the ECHL scoreboard in round one of the playoffs. And, of course, we're going to go to the other South Division semifinal, the Greenville Swamp Rabbits hosting the Florida Everblades. Game three of that series. That series is tied one game apiece, and the game is also tied one apiece. Levko Koper for Florida, Alex Iaruo for Greenville. And that is through one period of play. And as we talked about, or at least teased at the tail end of the first period, Florida playing without their captain, as John McCarron is serving the first of a two-game suspension for him for a major kneeing penalty from game number two. Elsewhere around the league, the Wheeling Nailers have a 2-0 series lead over Fort Wayne, and both of those wins were in Fort Wayne. Game three comes back to Wheeling tonight, where they can try and take a commanding lead, but it's Fort Wayne now who is turning the tables. It's the Comets with the advantage after one period of play, 3-1. Fort Wayne on top. A doozy of a series between the one seed Toledo Walleye and the four seed Cincinnati Cyclones. This is game number four already. They're the only team, I think, that has game four tonight. Cincinnati leads that series as the four seed, 2-1, but it is Toledo with the early jump midway through the first period. They lead 1-0. Only other game tonight, actually, I take it back, this is also game four tonight. The Tulsa Oilers will host the Utah Grizzlies. Utah leads that series as the one seed in the Mountain Division, 2-1. Second period now underway. The Icemen have the puck behind their own net. They are on a power play, already on top by one and looking for more. Here's Harris over the blue line. Gets by one man, not by another. Atlanta will clear it away. Redirects back to Brassard. He'll take it behind his own net. Waits for Neely to skate by, leaving it for Panetta. Panetta with a self-pass off the boards, back behind his own net. Just 22 seconds to go on this power play. Panetta up the middle for Craig Martin through center. He'll chip and chase after it. Gets by him and centering feed. Forehand goes just wide. Comes back to the corner. The Icemen get it back. It was Nazarian who I think had that chance. Comes back to the Icemen. Harris at the right wing circle. Saucer pass for Panetta. Time expiring on the power play. Comes to Gerdukas. Into the center point, Panetta. For Gerdukas, one-timer blocked in front and it redirected back into the corner. Atlanta plays it high ahead. Oh, what a play by Panetta to force the offside. Xavier Bernard came out of the penalty box looking for the home run pass, and Panetta got back defensively just in the nick of time. He made a whale of a play.
Yeah, no, it was a great job. He recognized it. And, of course, you might have heard the clicking in the background. That was Brassard warning the D that the penalty's coming to an end to be mindful. Bernard coming out, and he did. And Panetta did. He had a good angle on the play as well. And Panetta was able to get back in time and enforce that play off. Otherwise, it might have been a break there for Atlanta.
Atlanta drives it into the Iceman zone. Oh, we've got Fang up here with us.
Fang is up here. He's got the popcorn.
The best third man in the business on the air. Not much for the words, but man, he does create some some extra atmosphere here. As Ben Howerchuk also creating some atmosphere with a good forecheck and a good hit, forcing Atlanta to ice the puck and getting the faceoff. Oh yeah, picture time here for Fang. Let's
there we
get
go.
All
it's
of us
a,
in
it's
there.
It's actually a video. It's actually a video.
Oh, it's a video.
Hey, we can do a photo though.
Yeah. Woo! Let's do it.
Okay, we got it.
All right.
I mean, how many selfies have we taken with Fang mid-broadcast?
Oh, I love it.
This year. I want to say we've done it at least four or five times.
At least.
We got to do a collage, like a picture collage.
All about multitasking up here.
Yeah.
We're one with the people.
Yeah, yeah.
And with the canines. Team's back to 5-on-5. Iceman right off the draw. Brown whiffed on his shot, gets it back, however. Somebody for Jacksonville, I think it's Harris. No, rather it's Lynch. Had his stick nearly ripped right out of his hands as Atlanta clears it away to the Jacksonville end. It's Panetta, left wing side. The Icemen, remember, going with 5 defensemen tonight and an 11 forward. Brown over the blue line. The Icemen are onside. Lynch with a centering feed. Unable to get the shot away. It was Howardchuk. Great effort there from Lynch. Now Berzola looking for the dead angle shot. It goes off the side of the net, and Atlanta clears it out of the zone. Puck bounces high into the air. Howardchuk tries to knock it away at his own blue line. Atlanta comes away with it, though. Holscher into the offensive zone. Turnaround shot deflected to the blue line. Thrower looking for a high tip up front, comes back to the blue line. Thrower takes a bump from Howe. Puck comes free for the Icemen. Howe off the boards, just over the line and out. Fans want a too many men on the ice penalty. They're not going to get it. That's the puck was tied up right at the Gladiator bench. Atlanta had no choice but to try and get guys off the bench there. Long slap shot from center ice by the Gladiators. Saved by Brassard. He's trying to play the puck himself, and he will work it ahead high off the glass into the Atlanta zone. Remember, Brassard in the final week of the regular season put a shot on goal with a clear out. That was midway through the second period, I believe.
Yeah, he did. It was a dynamite save made by Latham of Greenville. Let's keep that one out. I remember how impressed I was.
It was. Actually, it was first period now that I'm thinking of it because it came from the left to the
right. Oh, yeah, right. It was. Yeah, left to the right.
Atlanta into the offensive zone. Jacksonville plays it into the corner. Looking to clear it out as McKinnon. To Pottage holds in from the blue line. He'll try the opposite wing. Now it's Sean Giles rubbed out on the play. Jacksonville gets it towards the line. Lodermeyer with a bouncing puck held in by Turner. Man goes down for Atlanta off the puck. Giles with his hands up in the air saying, I didn't do anything, and the referee agrees with him. There was no call. And now it's Giles with the puck in his own zone. Sean Giles for Fortunato. Up the left side, it's McKinnon. Dances around one man, takes it to the Atlanta blue line. Nazarian looking to keep the puck in the zone with the help of McKinnon. And they do get it in deep, but the Gladiators have possession. It's Derek Tepatage. Tepatage right up the middle, feeding Sylvester. Double teamed on the play, centering feed from Atlanta. Knocked free by Jacksonville. Hustling for the puck is Atlanta. They'll hold it in and play it down low. Neely on it there. Poked away by Jacksonville. Into the near side boards. Neely will play it back into the corner. Tapping it forward is Friend. Can't clear it out. Some pressure from the Gladiators as the Icemen lead 1-0. Fortunato playing it off the boards. That is blocked. He gets it right back. Fortunato now working it into the corner for Gerdukas. Fortunato took a hit. Steal from Atlanta. Held in the zone again. Centering feed. Backhander goes wide. Great back check there from Christopher Brown. Always a solid 200-foot player. Great to have him back, especially on that shift. Atlanta still with the puck, however, in the zone. Finally, it comes free for the Icemen. It is Gerdukas for Nazarian. Nazarian skates to center ice. The Icemen need a line change. Nazarian chips and chases. Jacksonville will change up their defensive partners as Atlanta plays it around the wall, but the Icemen now get the turnover. Berzola in front, blocked in front, centering feed, looking for the wraparound attempt. Berzola couldn't quite get it. I actually wonder if maybe they go to replay for that because Nell's pad was partially on the other side of the goal line. I think that it was clean, but if I'm Nick Lucco, I'm asking just in case.
Yeah, it can't hurt to ask, but not certain that anyone's making that motion there, including Berzola. You would have thought he would have said, hey, have them take a look.
Yeah.
But he might have had the best.
If anyone would have known, yeah, he'd be the guy.
Right. But great presence of mind there by Berzola. He saw the opening, went for it, ended up being a quality chance there. So see, they decided to just let it go, and the faceoff's been driven down the ice.
Icing again against the Gladiators. So the Icemen took a little bit of a pushback here from Atlanta, I think, for about the last 3 or 4 minutes. And credit Jacksonville for getting another good shift back the other direction. So anytime Atlanta gets momentum, and look, you can't have momentum 60 minutes of the game. You're going to give up some momentum, little waves here and there, but you're going to try and get it back as quickly as possible. Now it's Jacksonville centering feed, looking for the stick of Sanchez was Panetta. It was just out of his reach. Icemen keep it in down low. Martin with Sanchez in the right wing corner. Martin, good feed to Panetta, center point, slap shot, just wide. Puck comes back to Nell, he'll cover it up. Nell saw it late, and Panetta just ripped one from 55 feet away.
Yeah, it's a great shot that time. Ricocheted off. Nels, he's been working the post. His back and forth has been really good there. His post had been guarded nicely there. We saw it on the wraparound attempt there by Berzola. And then that time, really thought the shot, I think he kind of leaned to the right, but then had to come back left when that shot went off the other way. But he had it covered there to make certain that nothing kind of banked in on him.
Faceoff will be to Nell's left. Jacksonville out shooting Atlanta 16-8. They lead 1-0. Chris Nell has been Atlanta's best player so far. Steal from Jacksonville in the offensive zone. It's Harris spinning away from a man. Harris to the circle. It is Giles now. Lost the handle. Here comes Atlanta on a great turnover. It's possible 2-on-1, but the back check of Fortunato blows the whole thing up. And now it's the Icemen the other way. Sanchez over the blue line for Martin. Right circle. Centering feed just out of the reach of Harris. Sanchez turned the blue line for Giles. Giles for Sanchez. Sanchez at the blue line. Knocking it into the corner. Fortunato activates behind the net. Trying to field Martin. A tough hit. Penalty coming on Atlanta. There's your touch. And Martin favoring a play. And now it's Howe going after Xavier Bernard. Because that was a very dangerous hit from Bernard. And now it's Martin that wants to whack a stick away from Mitchell Holscher.
Yeah, Martin went into the boards awkwardly there. That's a dangerous play. You don't want to see that. And see if we got a whistle here. And it looks like it's going to be the one penalty as it stands right now, but I don't think Hal's happy with just
not
that.
Not at all. You're going to do something to my guy, I'm going to answer, and you're going to have to come to me if you want to do anything about it.
Yeah, he had some words for Thrower, who's obviously the toughest guy that was probably on the ice there. Why, he was by far the toughest guy that was on the ice for Atlanta. He did not factor in on the play. The penalty is going to Bernard.
Bernard,
yeah, his second trip to the box here tonight. So just kind of an awkward hit there. And good to see that Martin was able to get up from it. It was kind of one of those head-first situations, you know?
Yeah, very dangerous hit into the boards. Martin was a couple of feet off the boards. I believe boarding is the official call. Just a two-minute minor. And the Icemen back to the power play where they have one power play goal and the second chance. At least the first half of it was extremely effective. We'll see what the Icemen can do this time. Gladiators win the draw, however. It's Davison moving it 200 feet behind the Icemen net. That's where Brandon Fortunato will start. Fortunato gets the call on this first power play unit this time. Fortunato to the left for Lynch. From center ice over the blue line, the Icemen are offside on the play. Jacob Friend couldn't keep his foot on the ice on the neutral side of the blue line. Jacksonville with maybe not the power play personnel you would expect on this first power play chance. Derek Lodermeyer with Luke Lynch and Christopher Brown up front at the blue line. It's a traditional 3-2 alignment with Jacob Friend and Brandon Fortunato. The Icemen have the puck at their own blue line. Fortunato gaining center. Now he's over the blue line. The Icemen with a clean entry in. Lynch, who has the only goal tonight, plays it down low. Atlanta clears it around the wall. Fortunato holds it in. Lynch to the blue line for Brown. Brown to the top of the umbrella. It's Fortunato. Fortunato back to Brown at the top of the circle. Let's one rip, blocked in front. Rebound cleared back to the line. Brown holds it in for Lynch, giving it up to Atlanta. Here come the Gladiators. Skating out shorthanded is Eric Neely. Defended by Fortunato. Fortunato got a piece of it. Icemen get the puck back. It is Brown in his own zone. 57 seconds to go on the power play. The Icemen will send out a fresh set of legs. Jacob Panetta now out onto the ice with Brendan Harris and Craig Martin, who is fine after taking that hit on the boarding call against Atlanta. Icemen play it in deep. Campbell tries to keep it along the boards. Nazarian looks to dig it free. Martin is there also. Harris helping out. It's 3-on-2 along the corner. And it does come loose toward the Icemen. Panetta, top of the circle. For Harris. Harris now in the high slot. Pivots, moves it for Panetta. He can't keep it in. Not a good feed there from Harris. The Icemen get it back at center ice. 18 seconds to go on the power play. Over the blue line, it is Gerdukas playing it down low, looking for Panetta. Panetta with a hit on the play. Gerdukas tries to knock it free. Can the Icemen get it to the blue line? Yes, they do. Martin, cross ice for Panetta. Panetta fanned on the shot, lost the handle, gets it back, and the Icemen still have the puck down low. Centering feed, Harris just wide. How did he miss it? His team's come back to full strength. Harris caught Nell moving the other direction. Jacksonville still with pressure. Nazarian tries to keep the play moving. Finally, Atlanta knocks it off the wall and out. Could be icing. It will be icing. And Brendan Harris has had two glittering opportunities in this game. One with a great save, and that one he puts just wide of the post.
Oh, they're just knocking on the door, and I'm just impressed with the way the power play is looking. It's creating pressure, and I think in a way, the momentum right now that Jacksonville is continuing to carry right now. So great job there. The Icemen just didn't execute on that there. I know they would love to get one more tally right now to get a little bit of breathing room here. But again, look at shots right now, Arlie. We're approaching the halfway point of regulation, and Atlanta's still with eight. And, you know, Atlanta did a pretty good job getting a lot of shots generated in that game, in that last game there. And Jacksonville, this is a little bit more their norm right now, getting back to that defensive style and limiting opportunities.
We have a stoppage in play as Chris Nell made another save. He has the cover up as well, and we will move to a commercial break. 11:43 to go in period number two. Jacksonville still maintaining this 1-0 advantage over Atlanta. This is Jacksonville Icemen Hockey.
NHL players have amazing talent, and some of the very best developed right here in the ECHL.
Beagles in, he scores!
Now, follow all your favorite ECHL alumni every night on NHL Network's primetime hockey show, NHL Tonight.
Both teams recognize how big this matchup is.
Fire save by Dubin. Rebound!
Goosebump stuff.
NHL Tonight, every night 6 Eastern on NHL Network.
Hi, everyone. This is Allie McDeal from the Best Bet Poker Rooms. Experience the popular Vegas-style game Fortune Pigao Poker. Both locations are now playing face-up Pigao. It's more fun to play than ever. You could win up to $25,000 on a single $5 bet. Come play at either Best Bet location today.
Thank you so much for being with us tonight. Along with Alex Reed, this is Arlie Johnson with you. Game 3 of the South Division semifinals. First round action, Jacksonville leads this game 1-0. They lead the series 2-0 and looking to add to that total tonight. The Icemen have been the better team and they do have the lead, but it is only a 1-goal contest. Icemen with a bomb from the blue line that's blocked by the Gladiators and played out to center. Atlanta continues on, puck bounces into the air, into the Jacksonville zone, and the Icemen come away with it. It is Berzola drifting to the right, feeds Lodermeyer onside over the right wing. Into the corner. Atlanta knocks it free. It is thrower for Sheen. Sheen with a drop pass from Michael Turner. Turner's over the blue line. Sheen moves it cross ice. There's Bernard. Shot on net. Save gobbled up by Brassard. No rebound. Confidently at the top of his crease. And Brassard not only making the big saves when he needs to, but he's not allowing many second opportunities either.
No, he really isn't. And he's been very calm and poised. I think both goaltenders playing very well here. And certainly Nell's been the more tested of the two, but when the chances have come Broussard's way, I mean, he's not allowed any second chances, no rebounds. His control has been very, very sound.
Faceoff will be to the right of Broussard. Lynch on the faceoff for Jacksonville, Holscher for the Gladiators. Holscher now gets tossed from the draw. Paul McAvoy will have to come in for it. Atlanta right off the draw. What a save by Broussard. Just got a piece with the tip of his glove and keeps it out. Gladiators hold it in. Davison from the blue line. Wrist shot in the screen. That goes wide. Comes to the far side boards. Holscher will rim it around behind the net. Bates, not sure if we've seen Bates all game thus far, but he got the centering pass away. Picked off there by Jacksonville. It is Brown to the blue line of Atlanta. No further than that. And Atlanta now takes it into the Jacksonville end. It is Giles feeding Brown. Brown lofts it into the Atlanta zone. This is going to be icing against Jacksonville with 10:40 on the clock in period number two.
And Arlie, one of the things too, and I don't know if you highlighted it early in the broadcast there, but it's a situation where even though the Icemen are playing at home, it is Atlanta kind of technically from the standpoint of the line change situation.
That's right.
They are getting the second change. The home team always gets the second change to counter what the visiting team puts on the ice. But based on the circumstance of the series, the first four games, which you don't normally see playing in the same building, tonight and I believe tomorrow Atlanta will get that second change when it comes to putting out lines onto the ice.
I actually believe it is only tonight, Raiders. Atlanta gets a shot away. Broussard with a big save, and he gets the faceoff and the whistle. And then Neely jammed at Broussard's glove. That's why the puck became dislodged. But I am glad that you mentioned that, Reader. That is a very important component for this game in particular tonight. that Atlanta, even though this game is in Jacksonville, they will act as if they are the home team, at least in terms of line changes and such. Do want to give a quick hello as Ian McKinnon steps out onto the ice. Want to give a quick hello to his dad, Dan McKinnon, who was here for game two, watching the Icemen win that one in overtime. He's back home in Whitby, Ontario, but I got a chance to meet Dan McKinnon after game two, and he is an absolute treat to talk to. What a blast that was, hanging out with him. I mean, Ian, definitely a cut from the same cloth as his dad, let's just say. And
yeah,
it was great having him here, and it's great having him up in Whitby now cheering on the Icemen from a distance.
No, it really is. And, you know, I mean, we've talked about it. It's a great time to say it. I was actually talking to Kyle McKenzie about McKinnon earlier during the pregame warm-up. He mentioned the Clark brothers, Emerson and Everett. And, you know, I just said, hey, you know, now knowing those three guys and what they bring to the table, you know, Whitby's a town. I'm not going in and, you know, ruffling any feathers, I'll tell you that.
No shot. Atlanta with a shot towards goal. Save is made. Rebound, and Broussard, I think, got a piece of that one, too. And it trickled just wide. Those were his best two saves of the night. A critical sequence there. And two stops from Francois Broussard as the Gladiators push for the equalizer. Icemen get it back out. They have a two-on-one the other way. Nazarian for McKinnon. Stick save made as Nazarian ended up getting the backhander away. It was supposed to be a pass. It ended up being a shot instead. Icemen still with the puck in the zone, though. It is Gerdukas for McKinnon behind the Atlanta net, centering pass, nobody there. Just as we were talking about McKinnon, he was part of that two-on-one rush, but he never could get the pass from Aaron Nazarian. Icemen back into the zone. Harris takes a hit in order to work it free. Man goes down for Jacksonville. Tough play. Could have gone either way for a call, but we will play on in the Gladiators now with a 3-on-2. It is Sheen, defended by Friend. Puck goes to the side of the net. Broussard will jam it up there, right up against the apron, and take a faceoff with 9:03 to go in period number two. We'll go to break once more with the Icemen still on top by one. 1-0 is your score. This is Jacksonville Icemen Hockey.
Don't forget, this game is being streamed live around the world today. Go to flowhockey.tv to catch all of the Icemen action and archived footage of the event. Flow Hockey is the live streaming home for the Icemen. Get the Flow Sports iOS and Android apps to watch the event live and on the go. Upgrade to a pro subscription and you can gain access to premium content on all Flow Sports sites. This includes more than 1,000 live events, original documentaries, exclusive training and technique videos, and much more. Follow Flow Hockey on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube to get the latest news and updates from the Icemen and other upcoming Flow Hockey events. FlowHockey.tv, the new streaming home of the Jacksonville Icemen and the ECHL.
Just be positive. Your Community First Mortgage champions make sure you get a great rate, a quick close, and can save you about $3,000 in closing costs. Apply at communityfirstfl.org. Community First Credit Union. Just be yourself. Federally insured by NCUA. Equal housing lender.
Atlanta trying to give a little bit of a push here. The Icemen, with the help of their netminder, Francois Broussard, still preserving this 1-0 lead. Crowd in full concert mode for Sweet Caroline from Neil Diamond as we resume live play. Icemen take it out of their own zone, bouncing puck to the blue line. Atlanta clears it right back out, and Jacksonville collects it their own line. It's Friend for Howerchuk, who will redirect behind the Atlanta net. Harris is going to be first on the puck. Him and Campbell tied up along the wall. Campbell wins the puck battle, and Atlanta clears out. 8.5 minutes to go in the second. Very defensive-minded game right now as the Icemen take it to the Atlanta line, and a steal now from Jacksonville. Martin up the left wing, can't get the shot away, drop pass looking for Howerchuk. He'll poke it to himself in the right wing corner, playing it underneath. Martin unable to get the puck away from Graves, and it is Gertler now for the Gladiators. Up the wall, held in by Panetta, leaving it for Lynch. Good feed into the boards for Martin, and the Icemen continue with this phenomenal forecheck. Lodermeyer into the corner, working the puck free from Graves. It is Lynch now at the half wall. He'll play it to the opposite corner. Lodermeyer hustles after it. And the Icemen just want the puck more right now.
That's great work right now by this unit here on this particular line.
Howe now helping out. Giles keeps the puck in. Howe with a forehand. Save is made by Nell with the left pad. Lodermeyer takes Gertler into the wall. Lynch wins the puck to the blue line. Finally, Atlanta clears out to center. Superb shift from that line, most notably Derek Lodermeyer and Travis Howe. Jacksonville back over the blue line. It is Lynch 2-on-2 with Lodermeyer. Lynch to the backhand, can't get the shot away. Trying for his second goal of the night. Atlanta takes it behind their own net. Graves stick handles up the left, chipping it off glass. That's by everybody. Icing is the call. And this at least defensive pairing of Jacob Graves and Dalton Thrower have to stay on the ice. They're already gassed, and now the icing call.
Yeah, and they're going to have to stay out there. And again, it's just due to the hard work. I mean, that icing, they just needed a breather, and they were just trying to get the clear, and they did right there. But great work. I really was hoping that line on that shift would find one back the net there, just because they were so deserving of it. Great work around the perimeter, winning battles, and just the hustle to get to the puck in that situation. Great job.
Face off to the left of Nell. Atlanta wins it. Thrower around the wall, pinching in from the blue line is Fortunato. Got a piece of it with the help of Gerdukas. They'll hold it in. Fortunato, near side boards, dropping it into the corner. Atlanta gets it free. Thrower has lost his stick. He tries to glove it ahead. We've got a whistle. They're going to call Thrower for gloving the puck. You can make a hand pass, but you can't grab it and throw it. And that's what Dalton Thrower did. And it's another power play for Jacksonville.
Yeah, and Thrower was one of those guys that was out on the ice for a really, really long time, Arlie. And again, those types of mistakes happen when you're tired. You're desperate just to get off the ice, get the change. And he had the furthest to go, because not only is he pinned down, he's had to go almost the length of the ice, but he's on the other side of where the benches are. He was just trying to make a play so he could get off there. And unfortunately, it just ended up not working out for him. And the Iceman, this power play, this new look power play, gets back to work. I'm excited about it.
Me too. I mean, that's the kind of stuff you need. It's a long postseason. You can't be in a power play drought the whole way through. Eventually, you'll get burned, and Jacksonville now does look good with this man advantage. It's Harris trying to drop it to the blue line. Knocked free by Atlanta, held in by Panetta at the right point. Good cross-ice look. Gerduk has had the puck caught in his skates. He has to play it down low instead. Jacksonville still with it, though. It is Nazarian on his backhand, hit from behind by Davison, and Davison clears out of the zone. Crowd didn't like that hit from behind as Panetta circles the back of his net, getting away from Hugo Waz. He slingshots around the back of the net. Panetta looking to go coast to coast, slips by a couple of men, takes it all the way to the corner. Centering feed, it is Nazarian, tries to center, goes to Gerdukas forehand, and it goes out of play. I think Nell got a piece of it. The rush from Panetta, and then Nazarian nearly finishes it off with the feed to Gerdukas, and the Icemen buzzing again with the man advantage.
Yeah, that was some good pressure. Great job by Panetta going coast to coast and couldn't quite finish it off, and he still tracked the puck down and was able to get rid of it to a teammate. I believe Nazarian was trying to bring that one back out in front, and I think they were going for a little bit of a bank for a moment, then didn't see that it was there. Instead went up to Gerdukas, just a little bit of deflection, got that one up and out of play.
1:17 to go on the power play for Jacksonville. Second unit comes on with Derek Lodermeyer, Luke Lynch, and Jacob Friend as that body up front, trying to create a little more size and a little more traffic in front. Brandon Fortunato at the blue line with Christopher Brown. And Atlanta wins the draw. They'll skate with it. Taking his time for the Gladiators is Greg Campbell. He'll play it behind the Jacksonville net. Icemen with it there. Still some time on the power play. Over a minute left on it. Fortunato stick handles right up the middle. Feeds it to the right. Jacksonville with a clean entry in. Brown will rim it around, finding Jacob Friend in the left wing corner. Friend to the blue line for Fortunato. To the right side, it is Brown. It jumps over his stick, but it stays in the zone. Atlanta now with a steal. They can't clear it again. Brown tries to knock it to the line. Atlanta gets the steal. They'll skate out to center. Neely 1-on-2. Friend defends. Neely got a backhander wide of the net, and it redirects to the near side boards for the Icemen. They've got a four-man rush for now. Over the blue line, Brown is onside, pass is deflected, and not out of the zone yet. How did Jacksonville keep it in? Luke Lynch at the right wing corner, loses it to Topatage, around the wall to the blue line, Jacob Friend holds the zone. Feeding Fortunato, Friend gets it back. Now it goes to the right side for Brown. Into the bumper, shot deflects on net, save is made by Nell, rebound for Jacksonville. Somebody lost a stick on the play as the Icemen still have the puck. Right circle, it is Martin looking for the centering feed, deflected by Atlanta. Cleared to the blue line and out of the zone, and Atlanta on with a 2-on-1. Holscher with Thrower. Deflected by Fortunato, that was a big defensive play.
Yeah, it really was, Harley. That was a 2-on-1 developing.
Now it's a 2-on-1 for Jacksonville. Harris for Howerchuk. Howardchuk's shot is deflected away. Icemen get it back. Both teams have had a couple of chances now with some odd man rush. Rushes in succession here, but neither of them resulted in shots on goal. 1-0 Icemen, 4:23 to go in the second period. They scored 3:18 into the game on a power play. Nothing since then for either club. Atlanta with a icing call. That was a unforced icing against Atlanta. And now another offensive zone draw faceoff for Jacksonville.
Yeah, that 2-on-1 that Atlanta had, it was kind of one of the situations where it timed out perfectly. You had one player who was without a stick trying to get off for a change. So the Icemen decided to get a wholesale change, but it happened at the exact moment. Thrower came out, and then it ended up being a 2-on-1. Fortunato recognized it. Phenomenal play to break up that pass across by Thrower, trying to connect on the other side. And Jacksonville, they've been really responsive. They've been really aware. I like the awareness that this team has played with here today in those situations.
Puck goes into the Jacksonville bench, going to equipment manager Matt Conte.
Yeah.
Matty is hilarious. Throws his hands up into the air. It just was a soft deflection towards him. He's got his hands up in the air like, oh my God, I can't believe it. He puts the towel over his head. Running for cover is Matty Conte.
Yeah, no, it was. It was great. Trying to make a personal tent.
And now it's time for the selfie world on the Jumbotron, everybody's favorite promotion right now. We're just watching along with everybody at the moment.
one of the best promotions there is, I'll tell you.
It's just too good. It makes us stop broadcasting.
We get mesmerized by it. We're back, though, folks. Don't worry. I'll tell you. Well, you and I have been on there a couple times.
Yes, we have.
I think that's why we look, because we're like, oh, gosh, they got us again today.
We have to be on top of our game, not just with broadcasting, but knowing that we could be potentially on the Jumbotron at any possible moment. Icemen looking good, playing well, leading still, but only 1-0. Keep waiting to see Atlanta's best tonight. Haven't seen it yet, but you feel like at some point, they're going to have their best, and the Icemen have to respond to it. And because of that, you want to see Jacksonville look for an insurance tally here. They've played well enough to get it. They just have not been able to get by Chris Nell. Icemen player goes down well off the puck. Sanchez wanted an interference call. Could have easily gotten one, but he did not get the call. Atlanta moves it deep into the Jacksonville zone. Berzola knocking the puck away from Sangun Sheen. Sheen now gets it back, feeding the line for Campbell. Campbell gives it up to Gerdukas, can't clear it out yet. Turner on the backhand, playing it into the right wing corner. Panetta will continue it along, but Atlanta still with possession. Moving it for Turner behind the net. Poked free, great read there from Jacob Panetta. Panetta starts the outlet for Sanchez, who will redirect out to center. Atlanta right back into the zone. It's Brassard behind his own net. Tries to get it away from Turner. Turner actually got the block on it, and Atlanta with some pressure now. It is Sheen on his backhand. Man goes down behind the play for Atlanta on a big hit. It was Sanchez, I think, delivered that hit as Brassard makes a save from a sharp angle. He'll take the faceoff and the draw will come to his left-hand side. 3:07 to go in the second period. And Jacksonville still on top, 1-0.
Yeah, power play goal looming large here. And you were talking about you haven't seen Atlanta's best yet. And we saw Atlanta's best there in that third period in Friday's game, too. I mean, they gave the Icemen everything they had, and it nearly paid off for them as they came back. They outshot Jacksonville in that period 16-4. Unbelievable. Just took it to the Icemen, scoring those three goals and scoring the tying goal with a tenth of a second left. But Jacksonville, again, overcame it, which says a lot about the character of this club.
Oh, it sure does.
You know, I mean, after kind of a little bit of a collapse there in the third, come back and get the win. That shows a lot for this young team. That was a big, more psychological win there for the club than anything.
Yeah, without question. Give Atlanta credit for getting it to that point. And I would even venture to say that Atlanta gave their best in the final 10 minutes of game one also.
Yeah.
They didn't score in those final 10 minutes, but I think that was largely due to Francois Brassard having his best goaltending of the series thus far.
Yeah, absolutely, and I agree with that. I mean, again, he was unbelievable too. Some of the saves that he made in that third period. So, again, we got a long way to go here in this one, Arlie, but I really like the game that Jacksonville's brought to the table here today in all phases.
Hugo Watt tries to go from the inside out on a move, but reading him the whole way was Jacob Friend. Just a fantastic textbook defensive play by Friend. Jacksonville tries to clear out. They can't do it yet. Tied up along the far side wall. Wah jams at it. The Icemen get it to the blue line. Not out. It's played into the opposite corner. McKinnon with a big hit onto Pattish, separating him from the puck. Jacksonville plays it to center ice. No further than that. Atlanta drifts back into their own zone to maintain control. It's to Pattish. Up the middle, nobody home. Comes right to Sean Giles for the Icemen. He'll circle the back of his net and stop right there. 2:08 to go in the second period. The Icemen still on top, 1-0. Sean Giles up the left wing. McKinnon redirects it, tried to get it into the zone, but it ends up going over the glass instead. And the faceoff will come at neutral ice with 2:01 on the clock. It's a Wednesday night, but Reeder, great crowd, I think, here for this Wednesday evening. The Icemen had about a week and a half to prepare for this one as opposed to last week. Yeah. They just had a few days to go and give the Icemen faithful a tip of the cap for this one, because this is a fantastic Wednesday night effort from the crowd tonight.
No, it really is. And of course, you got they're going to have the specials too there, but like the $2 beer and wine specials for all the Wednesday playoff games.
That
promotion
right.
Carrying over to the postseason, which also helps. But you're right. I mean, Jacksonville's come out here and really supporting this club here. It's not the greatest dates. I know it's Saturdays, and you know, those are the big nights. But, I love that this midweek crowd here, they're going to be getting into it. I have a feeling here as this game looms on. Boy, that crowd on Friday night, man, were they something too.
Yeah, there was a lot to be on your feet for that one, without question, as Atlanta carries out of their end. They'll tap it to the Jacksonville line. Icemen with it. It is Fortunato, indirect feed for Howarchuk. He'll backhand it safely off glass and out. It's a smart play. Even though it's a second period right now, you just can't do anything that is even a hint of a gamble. If you have a chance to make a safe play, you make it, as opposed to making a potentially risky play, because sometimes those risky plays will come back and bite you. Final minute now of period number two. Jacksonville with a long outlet pass. It is Harris ahead. Nazarian, forehand, score! 2-0, Jacksonville, as Aaron Nazarian beat Atlanta on a line change and then moves it through the wickets of Chris Nell. 54 seconds on the clock in the second period, and Jacksonville with that valuable insurance tally. It's 2-0, Icemen.
Gives him a little bit of breathing room here, but man, what a great job there by Nazarian to bust through. He's always there, Arlie, isn't he? I mean, it doesn't matter where. Great job by Harris that time to find and locate Nazarian. And Nazarian falling down, going to his knees, gets the shot off and gets this goal here in the final minute of regulation. And the Icemen, what a big spark that is for them. Aaron Nazarian coming up big here, and he seems to come up big in this situation.
Here's the award-winning Joe Massa.
Goal of the playoffs, number 22, Aaron Nazarian. Assisted by number 83, Brendan Harris, and number 74, Brandon Fortunato. Time of the goal, 19 minutes, 6 seconds. Once again, your Icemen goal scored by number 22, Aaron Nazarian, assisted by Harrison Fortunato. Time of the goal, 19:06.
Joe, thank you so much. The Icemen looking to keep this advantage going into the locker room. Puck trickles into the neutral zone. Foot race for the puck. Nazarian couldn't keep it in as he was trying to beat an Atlanta player to the puck. 30 seconds to go in the period. Gladiators play it into the Jacksonville end. Broussard tried to clear it behind his own net. It was blocked. He got it right back. And then the Icemen and Jacob Friend will just ladle it out to the zone. Uh-oh. Foot race for the puck. Now it's Gerdukas trying to get it free from Topadish. Bouncing puck. Icemen still battle for it. Finally, the Gladiators knock it out of danger. And it's the Gladiators into the offensive end. Gertler with a wrister. That is blocked by Friend. Comes free for Broussard. He'll cover it up. Clock stops with 2.6 seconds to go. And then it's Holscher and Panetta that will tangle behind the net. The bucket from Panetta is already off, and we'll see what we have for penalties here. If any. Faceoff, I believe, will stay in the Jacksonville zone with 2.6 seconds to go.
Well, we'll see what we got here. A little skirmish. We haven't seen a lot of that here tonight.
No. And Panetta, he just blow a kiss to the Gladiator bench? He's going to the locker room right now. Yeah, he does.
Yeah, I think he's got a little busted up there. I think he was kind of signaling here. He might need a He took a little shot there from Holscher right in the kisser.
Yes, he did. That makes me wonder if maybe Jacksonville ends up with a power play out of this. I would guess no, but I don't expect Jacksonville to be shorthanded. I would suspect it's going to be two minutes apiece, and that is what we get.
And I think that's the right call.
It is. I would agree with that as well. If the face-off, go ahead, Reader. Go ahead.
I just want to say something. It's so simple here, but look who's talking to the official right now. The captain with the
yes.
C, Christopher Brown. He hasn't done this in a while here. Obviously named the Icemen's captain at the beginning of the year and then got called up to Hershey in December 21st. And he's been up there ever since. They really like him, and I'm not surprised at all. But it's great to have him back. Just great to see him out there. Obviously he's got an assist on the first goal, but you know, just playing that captain's role. I know that was filled in admirably by Derek Lodemeyer and Aaron Nazarian and Jacob Friend and company. So
definitely good to have a C. It's the first time anyone has worn the C since mid-December for the Icemen. So 4-on-4 hockey for the next 2 minutes. Of course, there's only 2.5 seconds left in this period. Derek Lodemeyer can win this faceoff and head into the locker room. Jacksonville will build on the momentum that they already had from the first period, but let's drop the puck before we get that far. And Atlanta has looked good in 4-on-4 hockey in this playoff series as well, so the first couple minutes of the third period will be critical, I think, also. Faceoff to the left of Jacksonville netminder Francois Brassard. Derek Lodemeyer on the faceoff for Jacksonville. Atlanta wins it. Shot is blocked. Luke Lynch, and then Cody Sylvester can't pull the trigger on the second attempt. That was a big-time block from Luke Lynch. And remember that play, because Atlanta got exactly the opportunity they wanted.
They designed it perfectly there. Right off the draw, they got it to the wingers. They overloaded that left wing side for that faceoff there. And that one was hit hard right off the body of Lynch, who got in front of it. And you see a lot of that. There's no doubt about it. So great job by Lynch. And the Icemen have a 2-goal advantage heading into the second break.
That's a huge goal from Jacksonville in the final minute of period number two. Aaron Azarian's first of the postseason. Brendan Harris and Brandon Fortunato on the assist. For Fortunato, it's a pair of helpers for him on the evening. And what a big momentum builder for Jacksonville, as they are the team that, again, continues to be the one that looks like they're the desperate team, even though they are actually leading this best of seven series 2-0 coming into game three.
Yeah, now we got the all-important third period of play, as you like to say, and Arlie, hey, it's great. Jacksonville's got this lead. It makes you think, though, they got to bring it. And then, look, everything they've done at this point has been great. I love the 40 minutes they've played. They've got to close it out here with another strong 20 minutes here of hockey. And if they do that, I think they're going to be fine early here. But they can't allow the Gladiators to get that momentum and start believing. Because once they start to believe, we've seen it not once, twice this year.
Yes.
This Atlanta club has rallied from sizable third period deficits and to come back and in one case win in overtime and then lose in overtime. But Jacksonville doesn't want that. They need to close this game out. They've earned it up to this point. Now they just need to put another 20 together. I think they'll be all right.
Now that Jacksonville won game two in such a fashion after blowing a third period lead, there, if you make an argument that is actually a lesson for tonight, that maybe it will help Jacksonville realize, look, there's still plenty of work left to be done against this Atlanta team. And keep in mind, the Gladiators, they don't do it just to Jacksonville. They've done it to everybody.
Yeah.
They led the entire ECHL in most third period victories when trailing after two. They had 10 wins in that situation, more than anybody else in the league. And Jacksonville knows that. And so if they didn't know it already, they certainly know it from game two. We talked about it early in this game, about the keys to the game being maybe starting on time, which they did, and how to close out the game. Well, that part is left to be decided. We'll see if Jacksonville can close it out the way that they have for most of the regular season, because the Icemen did not lose a single game this year when leading after two periods, at least in regulation. They didn't lose a single one in that situation.
No, they did not. They were very sound, and they've been so good in those situations. And they know how to lock down a game. Obviously, the numbers back that up. So they're going to need it again here tonight, and we'll see how it plays out. But again, they've done everything right here this evening. They got to expect a pushback. This is going to be, a big-time pushback by Atlanta. They're going to have to give it their all here. Atlanta knows, okay, we're down to 20 minutes here. We're going to put ourselves in a big hole if we don't get it done. I would expect them to come out flying here. And, again, they did. I mean, go back to that third period of the game Friday early. I mean, again, very just lopsided and shot, 16-4.
Yeah.
I mean, the Icemen haven't really done anything like had a period to go against it like that. that I can recall in quite some time, maybe even ever. That's something you don't see very often. Usually it's the Icemen kind of limiting the shots in that third period. But, hey, you know, they found a way. They got it done. Now they got to just try to learn from anything that maybe they, maybe failed on there on Friday in the third period and get back to it here. And, you know, it was kind of funny, you know, talking to the coaching staff about that last second goal. And, you know, they were watching the video, and you see a lot of guys trying to play the puck and use their sticks there. And I think the lesson learned there in that situation was, yeah, maybe that might be the right time in a normal, you know, 10 minutes left in the period because you don't want to take a penalty. But,
right.
Hey, it was pretty much at the point where all hold, you know.
Drag a man down.
Yeah, yeah.
Take a stick with your hand.
Prison rules in the final 2 seconds. I mean, you know, I mean, because if you take a penalty there, hey, who cares, right? I don't know. But, hey, it was they really wanted to emphasize, hey, play the body more. You know, if these guys can't, they're not on their feet, they can't take the shot. And even if you take a penalty with 2 seconds left, well, you can probably tie the face off up and you've done yourself some justice. So, you know, hey, they were just saying, hey, no holds barred, go for it. So,
oh, yeah. Love the comment of prison rules in the final 2 seconds. That's Alex Reed. That's why he's the best. We'll take a break and come back in just a moment.
All right, maybe not to that level, but you know what I'm saying.
Oh, well, fine. I mean, it's all, misdemeanors are fine, I'm sure, you know,
yeah,
in that situation.
Yeah, exactly.
We'll come back in a couple minutes. We'll keep you updated around the ECHL scoreboard. It's 2-0 Icemen after two periods of play over the Atlanta Gladiators. This is Jacksonville Icemen Hockey.
Tonight's game is brought to you by the ECHL, celebrating its 34th season of affordable family entertainment. The ECHL would like to recognize the following league sponsors: AMI Graphics, official signage provider; Athletic Knit, official jersey supplier; Baron Rings, official championship ring supplier; BFL Canada Insurance and Sutton Special Risk, sponsors of the 2022 ECHL Hall of Fame induction ceremony; Flow Sports, the exclusive streaming provider of the ECHL; Geico, official auto insurance of the ECHL; The Fairley Group, official commercial insurance provider; Handbid, the official mobile auction app; Honigs, the official partner of the ECHL officiating team; Howie's Hockey Tape, official hockey tape and lace provider; In Glasgow, official puck provider; Migre Group, your source for game-worn jerseys; Sideline Swap, official online marketplace of the ECHL; and Warrior, exclusive on-ice equipment provider of the ECHL and title sponsor of the 2022 ECHL All-Star Classic. Catch all of the ECHL action live in high definition by logging on to flowhockey.tv.
Don't forget, this game is being streamed live around the world today. Go to flowhockey.tv to catch all of the Icemen action and archived footage of the event. Flow Hockey is the live streaming home for the Icemen. Get the Flow Sports iOS and Android apps to watch the event live and on the go. Upgrade to a pro subscription and you can gain access to premium content on all Flow Sports sites. This includes more than 1,000 live events, original documentaries, exclusive training and technique videos, and much more. Follow Flow Hockey on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube to get the latest news and updates from the Icemen and other upcoming Flow Hockey events. FlowHockey.tv, the new streaming home of the Jacksonville Icemen and the ECHL.
NHL players have amazing talent and some of the very best developed right here in the ECHL.
Beagles in, he scores!
Now, follow all your favorite ECHL alumni every night on NHL Network's primetime hockey show, NHL Tonight.
Both teams recognize how big this matchup is.
Fire save by Dubnyk, rebound!
Goosebump stuff.
NHL Tonight, every night 6 Eastern on NHL Network.
Hi, everyone. This is Allie McDeal from the Best Bet Poker Rooms. Experience the popular Vegas-style game Fortune Pai Gow Poker. Both locations are now playing face-up Pai Gow. It's more fun to play than ever. You could win up to $25,000 on a single $5 bet. Come play at either Best Bet location today.
What is your role in the fight against cancer? The answer could be as simple as driving your car. For many cancer patients, getting to and from treatment is one of their toughest challenges. The American Cancer Society needs volunteer drivers to help provide transportation for people in your community. Through the gift of a lift in your car, you can help patients take one more step in the road to recovery. Get in the driver's seat in the fight against cancer. To find out more, call your American Cancer Society at 1-800-227-2345 or visit cancer.org.
Tonight's game is brought to you by the ECHL, celebrating its 34th season of affordable family entertainment. The ECHL would like to recognize the following league sponsors: AMI Graphics, official signage provider; Athletic Knit, official jersey supplier; Baron Rings, official championship ring supplier; BFL Canada Insurance and Sutton Special Risk, sponsors of the 2022 ECHL Hall of Fame induction ceremony; Flow Sports, the exclusive streaming provider of the ECHL; Geico, official auto insurance of the ECHL; The Fairley Group, official commercial insurance provider; Handbid, the official mobile auction app; Honigs, the official partner of the ECHL officiating team; Howie's Hockey Tape, official hockey tape and lace provider; In Glasgow, official puck provider; Migre Group, your source for game-worn jerseys; Sideline Swap, official online marketplace of the ECHL; and Warrior, exclusive on-ice equipment provider of the ECHL and title sponsor of the 2022 ECHL All-Star Classic. Catch all of the ECHL action live in high definition by logging on to flowhockey.tv.
The Jacksonville Icemen offer discounted tickets for groups of 10 or more. Whether it's a company outing, a group from your school or church, or just a gathering of friends, the Icemen can help you set up a night of fun at a discounted cost. Other benefits include an intermission ride on the popular FanZam, a post-game group photo, or take a shot on net after the game. Ticket fundraisers are also available. For more information, contact the Icemen office at 904-602-PUCK. That's 904-602-7825, or visit us online at jacksicemen.com. Icemen Hockey, feel the freeze.
Best Bet Jacksonville and Orange Park are open and excited to bring you the best in poker, simulcast wagering, cocktails, sushi, and more. Visit bestbetjacks.com for more information. Best Bet, experience the best.
Welcome back to downtown Jacksonville. Arlie Johnson with you on Mixler and on flowhockey.tv. This is game three of the South Division semifinal series, round one of the Kelly Cup playoffs. The Jacksonville Icemen with a 2-0 lead in this game. They also have a 2-0 lead in the series, trying to extend that one to three. To the ECHL scoreboard we go. There are five total games in the playoffs tonight, including this one here. Also included in that is the other South Division semifinal. The Greenville Swamp Rabbits as the 4 seed are playing the Florida Everblades as the 1 seed. That series is tied 1 game apiece as we move into game three tonight in Greenville. And that game is also tied. It is 2-2 in that contest. Mario Gennaro scoring for Florida in the second period to give the Everblades a brief lead, but Greenville equalizes less than 2 minutes later on a tally from Nikita Pavlichev. So 2-2, Greenville and Florida after 2 periods of play. Elsewhere around the league, it is the Fort Wayne Comets as the number 2 seed. They trail the series, though, 2-0 to Wheeling. But right now it is Fort Wayne with the advantage here in round number, at least in the game tonight, in game number 3. Fort Wayne has the lead. 4-1 is the score at Wheeling. That's a big bounce back from Fort Wayne. Still 20 minutes left in that one. That is through 2 periods of play. The Toledo Walleye looking for a victory on the road tonight. They are in Cincinnati. This is game 4 of that series. The Cyclones, as the 4 seed, have a 2-1 series lead thus far, but it is Toledo who has the lead in this game by the exact same number. 2-1 is the score for Toledo. And they are underway in Tulsa as well. Final minute of the first period, the Utah Grizzlies with a 2-1 series lead over Tulsa, and they lead tonight's game as well by a score of 1-0. And that is where we are around the league. We'll keep you updated for sure with the contest between the Florida Everblades and Greenville Swamp Rabbits, because I know all of you Icemen fans want to know who Jacksonville could potentially face in round two. If it's Florida, it would be the Everblades who would have home ice in round two if Jacksonville advances. If it is Greenville, facing Jacksonville in the second round, it would be the Icemen who have home ice advantage in the second round against the Swamp Rabbits. We will take another break and return in a few minutes. It's 2-0 Jacksonville. Third period will be starting in just a couple of minutes. This is Jacksonville Icemen Hockey.
NHL players have amazing talent and some of the very best developed right here in the ECHL.
Beagles in, he scores!
Now, follow all your favorite ECHL alumni every night on NHL Network's primetime hockey show, NHL Tonight.
Both teams recognize how big this matchup is.
Fire save by Dubin-Grimo!
Goosebumps stuff.
NHL Tonight, every night 6 Eastern on NHL Network.
Hi, everyone. This is Allie McDeal from the Best Bet Poker Rooms. Experience the popular Vegas-style game, Fortune Pie Gow Poker. Both locations are now playing face-up Pie Gow. It's more fun to play than ever. You could win up to $25,000 on a single $5 bet. Come play at either Best Bet location today.
If you feel that passion is just the start, if you think practice is never over, if you believe speed limits are just for highways and Saturday mornings aren't made for cartoons, if you try, fail, learn, laugh, repeat, compete, respect, and unite, then you belong on our team. Join now at team.ccmhockey.com.
Just be confident. Community First makes smarter banking simple so you can relax knowing you're managing your money the right way, yours. Visit justbeyourself.com. Community First Credit Union. Just be yourself. Federally insured by NCUA.
Don't forget, this game is being streamed live around the world today. Go to flowhockey.tv to catch all of the Iceman action and archived footage of the event. Flow Hockey is the live streaming home for the Icemen. Get the Flow Sports iOS and Android apps to watch the event live and on the go. Upgrade to a pro subscription and you can gain access to premium content on all Flow Sports sites. This includes more than 1,000 live events, original documentaries, exclusive training and technique videos, and much more. Follow Flow Hockey on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube to get the latest news and updates from the Icemen and other upcoming Flow Hockey events. FlowHockey.tv, the new streaming home of the Jacksonville Icemen and the ECHL.
Just be positive. Your Community First Mortgage champions make sure you get a great rate, a quick close, and can save you about $3,000 in closing costs. Apply at communityfirstfl.org. Community First Credit Union. Just be yourself. Federally insured by NCUA. Equal housing lender.
The Jacksonville Icemen offer discounted tickets for groups of 10 or more. Whether it's a company outing, a group from your school or church, or just a gathering of friends, the Icemen can help you set up a night of fun at a discounted cost. Other benefits include an intermission ride on the popular FanZam, a post-game group photo, or take a shot on net after the game. Ticket fundraisers are also available. For more information, contact the Icemen office at 904-602-PUCK. That's 904-602-7825, or visit us online at jacksicemen.com. Icemen Hockey, feel the freeze.
Just be in control. With free interest checking and great digital tools, Community First makes smarter banking simple. Add an account at justbeyourself.com. Community First Credit Union. Just be yourself. Federally insured by NCUA.
Back with you in downtown Jacksonville. Arlie Johnson with you, along with Alex Reed. We are through two periods of play. The Jacksonville Icemen on top. 2-0 is your score in the game. 2-0 is the series advantage as well in favor of Jacksonville. So they are trying to take a commanding 3-0 series lead. And we're gonna give you a little bit of a taste of the atmosphere here in Jacksonville as soon as it gets started, because the third period hype music here is just on fire. And I wanna make sure that we can crank that up for you and just let it play just for a little bit. Even if you can't be able to see it and all the cell phone flashlights that are lit up, at least you'll be able to hear it, and it is something to behold, whether it's from a visual or audio purpose. We want to make sure we can keep you up to date on it, and maybe it'll fire you guys up too. Here we go. Third period just about set to go. If you were watching on flowhockey.tv, that included that video montage. The last scene of it was Ben Howerchuk's game winner last Friday night in overtime against Atlanta. So crowd is ready to go. Team continues to be fired up. And as we bring Alex Reed in, Reed, you couldn't ask for a better playoff style game thus far for Jacksonville. The only thing left is to finish it off.
That's exactly it. This is it. The Icemen didn't really finish off that third period on Friday. They got the job done, don't get me wrong, and found a way to win. That's what you got to do this time of year. But certainly a period they'd like to have back. They got a chance to rectify it now in a game in which they've been very sound all the way throughout. And they just need to continue to do what they do. They do this like they did in the first 40 minutes, and they play this period the same way. I think they should be in pretty good shape here. They just got to play a simple, smart game and limit the shots. And so far through two periods, just 13, they've done just that. Now we got some four-on-four action, though, Arlie. So we'll see what the open ice, see if the team can benefit from it.
Well, Atlanta did score in four-on-four play in game two. That's what started the comeback. Here come the Gladiators again, right out of the chute to start the third period in the offensive zone. To Pottage, right wing circle. Tries to throw it towards goal. It goes wide, comes to the near side. Sylvester, rubbed out of the play by Berzola, comes loose for the Icemen. It is Berzola in deep, chips it ahead for Gerdukas. Gerdukas curls back away from one man, and he'll start the attack with Nazarian. Gerdukas over the blue line, drops it for Nazarian, flips it to the left side. Fortunato had activated, but the pass wasn't there where he needed it to be. It comes back behind the Atlanta net, and the Gladiators with possession. Still 4-on-4 for another minute and 9. Atlanta to the blue line, they're onside. Nesbitt's pass is blocked by Giles, and again, the Icemen suffocating on defense. Fortunato slowly in front of his own goal. He's just standing between the hash marks in front of Brassard right now. Drifts to the left, skates behind the net. He'll stop there. The Icemen are in no hurry at all. Fortunato comes right back up the middle again. Drifts to the left, he'll feed it for Giles. Cross ice look, it's gonna be offside against Jacksonville. 39 seconds to go in the 4-on-4 situation. And for the Icemen, I really wanna see how Jacksonville responds in this one. I think if they can put this one away, in not just kind of just get to the finish line, but if they can kind of ascend in the remainder of this contest, I think it really sets up well for game four going up against Atlanta tomorrow night.
Yeah, it really could. They'll see an opportunity that they could. Again, we got to see how this one plays out. But, right now Atlanta, knowing that if they can find a way, to get the W here in this game, Arlie, then everything changes here. Because now, because 2-1, we talk about what a big swing game this is. Now it becomes a 2-1 series, but also, they technically kind of get that home ice in a weird way because, they'll have three home games potentially if they can run the table here. So you're right. It's just, what's going to happen here in this period? Who's going to respond to that scenario here? A lot hanging in the balance here. Potentially the series hanging the balance on this period, Arlie.
Yeah, and you know what? Even if Jacksonville holds on to this one and goes up 3-0, I certainly would feel the exact same way tomorrow because you're right. One Atlanta victory here, whether it's game one or game four, automatically gives Atlanta home ice for the entire series.
Right,
yeah. And it can change everything. It would be the most tenuous 3-0 advantage you could possibly have.
Yeah, I know. It's true. So, it's just the prospect here of the series and the Icemen having the first four games of the series here on home ice. What an opportunity that got presented to Jacksonville. It's frustrating for Atlanta that this is the way it played out, even though they're the higher seed. But sometimes it's the way the cards fall. And for the Icemen, it was an opportunity they had a chance to seize, and they still had that opportunity at their grasp.
Atlanta in the offensive zone. It is Graves, defended by Lodermeyer. Rister from 55 feet away. Broussard easily gloves that one. The defense has been strong in front of him. Broussard has had to make a few timely saves along the way. A couple of them in particular in that second period when it was only a 1-0 score, when it was very, very dangerous. You don't want to give Atlanta an opportunity or even a breath of life, and thus far the Icemen have not done that. 8 more seconds, each team will get a man back out onto the ice. It's 4-on-4 for the moment. Lodermeyer against Sheen on the draw. Lodermeyer wins it cleanly to Berzola, but he cannot clear it out. Atlanta with Graves playing it down low. Sheen defended by Friend behind the net. Friend couldn't find the puck. Atlanta keeps the puck in. 5-on-5 now, we will skate. As the puck goes to the blue line, Gladiators still with it. Campbell wristing it intentionally wide, comes off the boards to the far side, and the Icemen with it. It is Hawerchuk dancing around Sheen. He'll get to center ice and backhand it in. Campbell gives chase. Hawerchuk lifted his stick, got the puck loose for a third man, but it was Atlanta still with it, and now it's the Gladiators, a 3-on-2. McAvoy to the right for Sheen on the right. Centering feed, Gertler to his forehand. Couldn't get the shot away, he'll feed it to the line. Thrower with a drive, blocked by Lodermeyer. Another great sellout from an Icemen player defending in front of their net. And Jacksonville will skate out. It is Howe from center ice. Howe tries to tap it away from Bernard. Bernard moves it to the Icemen blue line. D to D, it's Fortunato for Giles. Hawerchuk redirects in behind the Gladiator net. Nell with it there. He'll swing it around for Thrower, redirecting it free. Comes for Atlanta. Skating up the right is Hugo Watt. Defended beautifully by Giles, who sweeps it behind his own net. Jacksonville looks to clear, held in, shot in the screen, save is made. Rebound and another save made by Broussard. A pair of them that time, the second one on Hugo Waugh.
Yeah, I was just thinking to myself, seeing Hugo Waugh here, when's he gonna bust out here in this series? And he really did right there. It's almost like, why get those thoughts out of my head here? But, you know, again, he's such an explosive and dynamic player. And, you know, another player such as Sylvester, you know, he kind of disappeared in that first game, but boy, he came up with vengeance there in game 2, 3 points. We know what the veteran can do there. He's a high scoring guy, but great saves there by Broussard. And as you said, had to make 2 of them. And a great job here so far by Jacksonville in the early going this period.
And the Icemen win the faceoff as well. They'll chip it off glass and out. Nothing fancy at all.
Arlie, we'll see if maybe there's any kind of effect of the 5 defensemen that the Icemen dressed here tonight. Maybe see if that plays a role here as this game wears on.
Well, we certainly hope not.
No, yeah.
Obviously, but
no,
yes, it is something to watch without question as the game moves along, you know, going into the third period. You're right, that's a great observation, Reader. Thus far, I think it has been, through 40 minutes, a brilliant coaching decision by Nick Luca.
I was just gonna say, so far, I think it's worked out well.
Shot from Atlanta is blocked in front by the defense. Comes free for the Icemen. They cannot clear it. Neely with a wrister. Save is made. Rebound. Centering feed. And that was stolen by Jacksonville. So Broussard with the initial save. And then Jacob Panetta with the steal on the seam pass.
And the thing, too, Arlie, about the you know, 5 defensemen here, you know, maybe that's a decision that's not made if you're playing your third game in 4 days or something such as that. Both teams have had a good amount of time off. They haven't played since Friday, so you know, you've got some well-rested guys on both sides, and that certainly played, I'm certain, a factor in the decision today as well.
Offside called against Atlanta. Yeah, those are all the inner workings of what to do, and I, you know, as soon as I saw Christopher Brown was sent back down to Jacksonville tonight, you know, immediately I start thinking, well, if he's in, who's out? If I was thinking it, I know Nick Lucco and Brandon Machinter were thinking it. You know, what do you do? I asked him pregame, was it a hard decision? And he said, well, you know, we had some thinking to do because obviously it does kind of misalign your forwards in defense, but we wanted to go with what we felt was the best lineup for tonight, and this is the way we felt it was needed to go. And in Nick we trust. And so... So far, it has gone the right way. It's been a fantastic decision. And now it's Jacksonville 2-on-1. Harris with Brown, they're onside. Harris couldn't take the saucer pass, and the Icemen come away empty on another odd man rush. The frustrating part isn't so much that they haven't scored. Now it's Atlanta the other way. McAvoy with a forehand, glove saved by Broussard. He'll take the faceoff as McAvoy handled a bouncing puck that Fortunato could not handle, and Brassard was there. That was a big one.
Yeah, it really was. And you know, oftentimes when you get an odd man rush, you got to watch the other way because it can't go the other direction for you where it's an odd man rush for your opponent. But again, Brassard coming up with the task there. And good job by the Iceman defense. They were beat, making some plays at the stick, but nothing too aggressive that the officials determined that needed to be a penalty. So great job all around there.
Atlanta in the high slot. Schoen with a shot. Kicked aside by Brassard. Rebound goes off the side of the net from Atlanta on the second attempt. Gladiators, here comes their push, it looks like. Travis Howe in the near side corner. Swings it for Lodermeyer. Golfing it out of the zone. Dalton Thrower beats Ben Howarchuk to the puck. It was Thrower who Howarchuk beat to the net on that overtime game winner in game two. Jacksonville back into the zone. Driving it in is Howarchuk. Howe gives chase against Bernard. Finishes his check and rattles the glass. Atlanta breaks out of the zone, but the fans sure don't care. They love that hit from number 24 in gray for the Icemen tonight. Now it's Jackson. Oh, big collision with a couple of Icemen players. And Gerdukas is down. Travis Howe ran into Abbott Gerdukas, and here comes Jake Reardon.
Oh, well, they don't like that hit there. Goodness gracious, a couple of players pivoting together, and Howe immediately waved Jake Reardon on, and don't like to see this, you know, just kind of a blind hit, accidental, but certainly Abbott Gerdukas just got hit hard that time there in that situation. You hate to see it. And the Iceman immediately tending.
Yeah, all eyes are on Abbott Gerdukas right now. He is up on his feet with assistance from Jacob Panetta and from Travis Howe. Jake Reardon is out there as well. Gerdukas skating back to the bench, and hopefully it was just nothing more than, you know, stunning him with that hit, because it was friendly fire.
Yeah, you know, it was.
Travis Howe and Gerdukas just collided as they were both moving in opposite directions. They didn't see each other.
Yeah, that was a jolt that Gerdukas.
And Howe feels terrible about it. You can see as he puts his hands over his face right now.
He did immediately. You can see he just kind of crumpled down, and yeah, he's going to go to the back row there. Yeah, he's got the helmet off. He's, you know, very frustrated with himself. He's got the towel over his head. You know, I mean, these guys go to war for each other, and Howe knows he's like, one of our top guys, and, you know, I didn't mean to get in his way there. He feels terrible, and you can see the concern immediately after the hit. Was down on his, you know, jumped down to his knees and, you know, started consoling his teammate and waving him off there, even just before the whistle was blown. So just a tough situation, one of those accidental freak things that happens there, and we hope that Gerdukas is all right.
Now it's Atlanta into the zone. Bates on the far side. He'll drop it underneath. Going back to that incident with Travis Howe going to the bench, I also want to credit the Icemen as a team, because they are team from top to bottom. You saw Derek Lodermeyer tap the top of Travis Howe's helmet because he wants to make sure that, you know, they are there for Travis as well. And now we've got some plays going on right at the near side glass.
Can't see anything right now.
The linesman trying to separate a couple of players from behind. It's Luke Lynch for Jacksonville. Can't tell who it is for Atlanta. They're both on the ice right at the near side penalty boxes.
Gertler
for Atlanta.
Yeah, it is. Gertler. These guys are almost identical players. Arlie and Lynch and Gertler, they play that kind of gritty physical style there, and not surprised, the two of them coming together, this is the result.
And now it's Lynch. Is Lynch shaken up too? He might be. Gertler heads into the box. Now Lynch with a smile on his face. I think he is okay. And we'll see what the penalties are going to be from this one. We'll take a brick break. We'll come right back. We'll tell you what these penalties are going to be. It is 2-0 at Jacksonville. 13:42 to go in period number three. This is Jacksonville Iceman Hockey.
Tonight's game is brought to you by the ECHL, celebrating its 34th season of affordable family entertainment. The ECHL would like to recognize the following league sponsors: AMI Graphics, official signage provider; Athletic Knit, official jersey supplier; Baron Rings, official championship ring supplier; BFL Canada Insurance and Sutton Special Risk, sponsors of the 2022 ECHL Hall of Fame induction ceremony; Flow Sports, the exclusive streaming provider of the ECHL; Geico, official auto insurance of the ECHL; The Fairley Group, official commercial insurance provider; HandBid, the official mobile auction app. Honig's, the official partner of the ECHL officiating team. Howie's Hockey Tape, official hockey tape and lace provider. In Glasgow, official puck provider. Migray Group, your source for game-worn jerseys. Sideline Swap, official online marketplace of the ECHL. And Warrior, exclusive on-ice equipment provider of the ECHL and title sponsor of the 2022 ECHL All-Star Classic. Catch all of the ECHL action live in high definition by logging on to flowhockey.tv.
We are back, and it is a power play for Jacksonville. So the extra penalty for Gertler and the Icemen trying to extend their lead, not only in the game, but in the series. Atlanta gets a clear out. This is a big moment, I think, in the game, Reader, to try and move up by three in this contest.
Yeah, no, I agree with you here, Arlie. This is a big moment here in this third period of play.
Nazarian gives it up behind the Atlanta net. Gladiators will clear it out. It goes all the way to Francois Brassard. A minute 18 to go on the man advantage for the Icemen. Panetta comes up the middle. It is out of his zone. Feeding for Harris. He'll rim it around. Nell stays in his crease. Nazarian lets it go for Martin at the right circle. Martin with a drop pass for Panetta, and the Icemen set up shop in the zone. Panetta at the circle, throws it down low, deflection, centering feed. Harris couldn't get the shot away.
Wow.
I think Nell maybe made the save there. Jacksonville can't hold it in the zone. What a great redirect first from Nazarian, and then Harris with a second effort.
Yeah, that second effort there, I think that was a good big-time save there by Nell, point-blank range. Second big save he's made on Harris here today. Love the intuitive play there by Nazarian, looking for the redirect. Standing next to the post, no, that was quite the angle he had to get through.
Icemen are onside on the left. It's Howarchuk looking for a man in the bumper, deflected away and cleared out by the Gladiators. Friend will give chase. He'll win it ahead of Eric Neely. 20 seconds to go on the power play. So a couple of good chances here for Jacksonville. Every power play has had at least something positive from it. There haven't been any completely empty chances tonight for Jacksonville. One last chance for Jacksonville, trying to keep the puck in the offensive zone. Atlanta comes away with it. They will clear it to the blue line, and Fortunato had it glance off of his fingertips, and it comes out to his own zone. Teams are at full strength. Atlanta with a steal. Bates, forehand, save is made. Rebound, Atlanta still with it. Backhander slips wide, and Brassard bails out his teammate as Jacksonville plays it away.
Yeah, you just can't make those mistakes in a situation. I mean, it's the last thing you want to give up there would be a shorthanded goal in that situation there. I mean, yeah, you want to try to score, but you don't want to give one back.
Jacksonville plays it ahead. They may have a two-on-one developing. McKinnon with Gerdukas, who's back on the ice. So good to see him. Gerdukas gets a backhander wide on the play. He gets it back behind the net. Gerdukas towing it, playing it up high. It is Panetta. Panetta, wrister in a screen that is blocked. It goes to the opposite corner. Zach Berzola comes in from the blue line to hold it in. Trying to tap it free. McKinnon gives it up to Holscher, and the Gladiators will skate out to center. Oh, thank goodness we have Abiker Duckus back out onto the ice as Atlanta gets a centering feed going wide. Comes all the way to center. McKinnon trying to tap it free for Howe. McKinnon tripped up on the play. But again, let's go back to Abiker Gerdukas.
Yeah,
everybody was holding their breath, and it's so good to see him.
Yeah, back out there, went down the tunnel, got checked out by the doctor. They say he's good to go, so he's back out there. It's a great sight, without question. That's the big storyline on that shift.
Atlanta with some pressure. Davison closes, fires, glove save made by Brassard. For him, I would call it a relatively routine save because there was no traffic in front. If he can see it from 40 feet or further, which is what that one was, about 40, he'll eat that alive all night.
Yeah, it was a perfect lane. There was no traffic there. He saw it all the way in. He was able to catch that one right there in the mitt and snare that one. But a good lane there. And, of course, Atlanta's going to take that shot, whether there's traffic there or not. They were trying to. Wall was set up in front, but great job by Jacksonville. That was Berzola fending him off nicely and keeping him from getting in front of Brassard and setting up any kind of screen or tip shot opportunity.
Faceoff control by the Icemen, playing it to the blue line, not out yet. Atlanta into the right wing corner. Hugo Waugh kicks it onto his stick. Ridden off the puck by Giles. Neely helps out for Sylvester. Three veterans all up front here for Atlanta. Graves with Martin defending. Marty with a great, excellent effort from him, keeping the puck bottled up along the corner. Now he chips it ahead. Finds an open man, and the Icemen will play it out of the zone. Campbell beats Brown to the puck. The Icemen get it right back. It is Brown letting it go. Campbell takes it back for the Gladiators. Sylvester is onside. For Neely at the left wing corner. Slipped up on the play, centering feed. Broussard stuffs it, holds onto the puck, or at least he tries to hold onto the puck. Atlanta knocks it free, and we play on. It is Campbell behind the net. All the way to the opposite wing, and Jacksonville comes away with possession. Zach Berzola, 3-on-2 maybe develops. Berzola, drop pass for Lodermeyer. Lodermeyer goes behind the net, waits for a trailer in front. Goes by everybody, and it comes out to center ice. Fortunato picks it up. 9:04 to go in the third period. Jacksonville has played an excellent third period so far. Not flashy, but just enough to do the right things. And again, Francois Broussard has been good when called upon in this third period. A couple of key saves. Now Atlanta all alone. Forehand and a score. Just as I say that, it's Mitchell Holscher that gets the goal with 8:49 to go. The Gladiators are on the board. Here we go again.
Yeah, here we go. And again, you look at that situation there. The Icemen just didn't win the battle that time. Atlanta did. They were able to find it to Holscher, and Holscher beat his man right there in the slot. Was able to break towards the net. Very patient. And Broussard, all he could do was get the pad over, but the shot went high. A lot of space behind him, and Atlanta gets the next big goal here in this game. And here we go. Things have tightened right back up. It's a one-goal game again.
It's Holscher's first of the postseason. 11 minutes, 11 seconds of the third period. And don't go anywhere just yet. The Icemen know what Atlanta brings to the table in the third period. They're the best team in the entire ECHL when trailing after two. Atlanta is out shooting Jacksonville 11-2 in this period.
Yeah, and we saw that the last game. They outshot Jacksonville 16-4 in the third period of Friday's game. So this is Atlanta club just coming in strong in the third period with an all-out assault.
And lots of time left. It is Bates for the Gladiators, flipping it in on the backhand. Panetta gives chase. Turns on McAvoy, leaves it for Gerdukas. Not out, slap shot, save is made. Rebound swept into the corner by Panetta. And the Gladiators continue to pressure. Davison's shot is blocked by Lynch. Lynch tries to come out to center ice. Ridden off the play by Davison. Fans want to call for interference. They will not get it, and the Gladiators come away with possession in their own zone. Diving to sweep it out of the zone is Davison. Jacksonville gets it back. The outlet pass for Harris, who will chip it in high off the glass. To Potash, first on it for the Gladiators behind his net. Turnover for Jacksonville. It is Martin trying to play it down low, knocked free, still loose. The Icemen keep it in, playing it underneath. It is Harris against Davison. Harrison plays it around the wall. Fortunato pinches in from the blue line. He'll keep it in. Fortunato at the left wing circle. Fortunato turns to his forehand all the way to the blue line now is Fortunato. Fortunato gets some space at the right circle, tries the shot, it is deflected, it ends up out of play. We have 7:16 to go in the third period, and it looks like we're coming down to the wire yet again. Jacksonville 2, Atlanta 1. This is Jacksonville Icemen Hockey.
The Jacksonville Icemen offer discounted tickets for groups of 10 or more. Whether it's a company outing, a group from your school or church, or just a gathering of friends, the Icemen can help you set up a night of fun at a discounted cost. Other benefits include an intermission ride on the popular FanZam, a post-game group photo, or take a shot on net after the game. Ticket fundraisers are also available. For more information, contact the Icemen office at 904-602-PUCK. That's 904-602-7825, or visit us online at jacksicemen.com. Icemen Hockey, feel the freeze.
Best Bet Jacksonville and Orange Park are open and excited to bring you the best in poker, simulcast wagering, cocktails, sushi, and more. Visit bestbetjacks.com for more information. Best Bet, experience the best.
Along with Alex Reed, Arlie Johnson with you, a nail biter once more here in Jacksonville. The Icemen have already won a pair of nail biters in this series, leading the series 2-0. And it looks like if it's going to go to 3-0, they'll have to do it in the exact same fashion.
Yeah, we're coming down the stretch here. It's that go time right now. And what do they call it, the Witcher hour or something? When that's what we're coming down to right now. Where things can completely turn around quickly.
Broussard makes another save on a deflection from Eric Neely. Puck into the near side corner. Neely comes away with it. Turnaround shot. That goes wide. Tricky bounce off the stanchion. Graves pinches in from the blue line. He'll hold it in the zone. Gerdukas defends. Graves looks to get a centering feed away. Zach Brazola was there. Great defensive positioning, but he can't clear it out yet. It is Campbell dropping it down low. Panetta rides Sylvester into the boards. Gladiators with more pressure. Hugo Waugh all the way to the blue line. One-timer goes wide. Crazy carom right back to Brassard, who was already on the seat of his pants, but he recognized where that puck was going to go off the boards right back to him. He reached behind him with his glove in order to get the faceoff.
Yeah, and they just made a change, Atlanta did. So that player that shot it was just rushing full steam. They fed it up to him, lots of space, just teed off the shot. I believe that was Waugh with the shot, if I'm not mistaken. Could be wrong there, but it did launch wide, ricocheted back wide. And, again, it's actually advantageous that Brassard was already kind of down in that situation because he was able to make a quicker play on the puck.
Icemen have got to try and find a way to regroup here and just continue to play sound, smart hockey. But Atlanta, give them credit yet again, outshooting Jacksonville 13-2 now in this period. They have the only goal of this period thus far. Mitchell Holscher from Sangun Sheen and Derek Nesbitt. Faceoff will be to the left of Brassard. It's Luke Lynch for the Icemen. Mitchell Holscher for Atlanta. Holscher just scored on his last shift on the ice. Puck is down. Lynch comes away with it. Atlanta sweeps it back towards goal. It goes wide. Gladiators pick it up again. Holscher rimming it around. Nesbitt cycles it underneath. And the Icemen finally come away with possession. It is Friend up the boards. Lodermeyer tries to clear. Gets it to the blue line, not out yet. Atlanta holds it in yet again. It is Thrower to the left circle for Bernard. Bernard tries to center, knocked aside from the goaltender, Brassard. It ends up behind the net. Friend will play it around the wall. Loose for Atlanta, shot is blocked. Bouncing puck at the blue line, the Gladiators hold it in. Loose there, it is Sheen. Can he get the centering feed away? Putting it wide was Nesbitt. It is all Atlanta right now, and the Icemen are just hanging on. They need to get a clear. Howe finally able to do so, and it's too soft for icing as well. And Jacksonville hustles to the bench for a line change.
Yeah, we've seen it. It's the same problems, Arlie. Just the Icemen can't get to the puck, can't win the battles, and they can't get the puck out on some of these clears. Atlanta's done a marvelous job in all three games here late to put the Icemen on their heels in these high-pressure situations and keep the puck in the zone.
You addressed the Icemen and their five defensemen tonight, and we'll have to watch what their stamina level is in the tail end of this game. Jacksonville looks for a steal in the Atlanta zone. The Gladiators just beat Hawerchuk to it. Now it's Gertler over the blue line, flipping it in towards Brassard. He'll glove it and take the faceoff to his right. 5:06 remaining. One final media timeout. We'll be back in a minute for the final five. It's Jacksonville 2, Atlanta 1. This is Jacksonville Icemen Hockey.
NHL players have amazing talent and some of the very best developed right here in the ECHL.
Beagles in, he scores!
Now, follow all your favorite ECHL alumni every night on NHL Network's primetime hockey show, NHL Tonight.
Both teams recognize how big this matchup is.
Fire save by Dubnyk! Rebound!
Goosebump stuff.
NHL Tonight, every night 6 Eastern on NHL Network.
Hi, everyone. This is Allie McDeal from the Best Bet Poker Rooms. Experience the popular Vegas-style game Fortune Pie-Gal Poker. Both locations are now playing face-up Pie-Gal. It's more fun to play than ever. You could win up to $25,000 on a single $5 bet. Come play at either Best Bet location today.
Down the stretch they come. 2-1 Jacksonville, 5:06 on the clock. And, Reader, let's set the scene for you and talk about what Jacksonville needs to do. Maybe what they need to do a little differently right now with the one-goal advantage.
Yeah, I don't know what the, you've seen it now. I mean, lots of shots here. Again, I don't know where we're at here. It was it's 11-1 last time I checked
14-2.
Here. Yeah, 14-2. Again, it was 16-4 Friday. I don't know if the Icemen just kind of go into a defensive shell and that's it, but I say, hey, go back to, maybe what got you here in the begin with, especially in the first two periods where you're applying that pressure, controlling the tempo. Because you're not controlling the tempo when you're on your heels and the puck's just in your own end and you're running around just trying to hold on. That's not controlling the tempo. Atlanta's doing that right now. So I'm not certain what, the mindset is there. The Icemen, I know they don't want to give up a big play, but you really haven't given up too many today, at least in the first two periods. And Atlanta right now, this is boding well for them because you got a veteran group that knows that, okay, if we can get some momentum going here and get some pressure, we'll get some turnovers and maybe be able to convert on those opportunities. And that's how they got the goal there from Holscher.
Gladiators have the puck in their own zone. It's Tim Davison. He's made a world of difference also for the Gladiators, his return from injury tonight. Atlanta clears in. Brassard behind his net, leaving the puck for Berzola. Martin tries to redirect it ahead. It is blocked by Atlanta and played to an opposite wing. Panetta first on it for Hawerchuk. He simply ices it. And Jacksonville definitely on their heels right now with 4:34 to go.
Well, I think Panetta was trying to get the puck out, and then he had Hawerchuk along the boards. If he can get a piece of it, you know, trying to avoid the icing situation there. But it's not the case here. It is icing. Hopped over the stick of Hawerchuk, and now the faceoff back down in the zone.
The Icemen will send out Brendan Harris for this faceoff against Mitchell Holscher. Draws to the right of Francois Brassard. Atlanta wins it, but it was too hard for Xavier Bernard to handle. Comes all the way back to the Atlanta line. Nesbitt curling back into his own end, being hounded by Harris, forcing the errant pass, but the Gladiators get it right back and they'll play it in. Comes to the far side wall. Harris gets a stick on it, bounces behind the Iceman net. Atlanta with the puck. Bernard from the blue line, walks the line, wrister in a screen, blocked in front, never reached the net. Comes to the near side for Nazarian. Again, the Iceman cannot clear it out. Brassard forced to make a save. It was going to go wide anyway, but he just wanted the faceoff more than anything else. But we've talked about this more than a couple times tonight, that the Icemen have had clear-cut opportunities to clear the zone, and they're just not doing it, at least not with the consistency that head coach Nick Lucco would like.
No, absolutely not. And again, there was a lot of time for the Icemen to get rid of that puck. They went for a backhand flip off the boards. You don't get quite the accuracy and the speed that you want to get it out. Plenty of time in the forehand. You had a man rushing up. You could have even fed it to him, but there were a lot of other options. That one wasn't really the best one. And again, it ended up staying in the zone. And this is just becoming a little bit of an issue here. And I think Atlanta's been exploiting it here late in games.
And now it's Atlanta cycling the puck along the corner. Turner. Heard very little from Michael Turner all game long, but Atlanta has the puck behind the net. Friend defending on a man. Turner gets it back behind the net.
Good
topped
battle.
Away by Fortunato. He'll chip it up the boards. Again, Atlanta holds it in.
Unreal.
Man goes down. No call. Jacksonville play on. Can they get to the puck? Brown couldn't send away Nazarian despite the diving effort for a potential breakaway. Now it's Atlanta the other direction. Turner behind the Jacksonville net, down to 3:20 to go in the game. Atlanta centering feed, picked off by Jacksonville, cleared out by Travis Howe. Gladiators right back at center as the Icemen complete a line change. Atlanta clears in, Brassard blocks it behind his net, and now it's Atlanta changing up, and that allows the Icemen to get a clean exit out of their zone. It's Panetta for Lodermeyer. Lodermeyer to the blue line, no further. Atlanta breaks it up, and the Icemen can't get the puck in deep. Atlanta plays it to the Jacksonville line, and it's Sean Giles knocking it loose back into the Gladiator end. The Icemen won't mind just clearing in dump-ins as long as Atlanta doesn't threaten on the offensive side, but Atlanta now is into the offensive zone. They're onside. Hugo Waugh near side to the blue line for Davison. Davison plays it underneath. Brassard knocks it into the corner. Panetta takes the body on a man. Giles helping out. Can the Iceman get the puck away? No. It's Waugh to the blue line. Slap shot blocked by Howe. Total sellout by Howe with a diving block. Now it's Lynch with a block. Howe looks to clear. Held in at the line. Neely at the top of the circle. A Jacksonville player has lost a stick on the play. Davison with a centering feed. That's by everybody, and the Icemen catch a huge break. 2:07 to go in the game. Nell is still on the ice for Atlanta. He's waiting for a cue to go to the bench for a sixth skater. Jacksonville tries to clear it out. Atlanta holds it in. Berzola in the right wing corner. To his forehand, flips it into the air. It's batted at by Bernard. The Icemen get it back. This time they do clear it out. Six skaters on the ice for Atlanta. The Gladiators have the puck behind their own net. 1:40 to go in the game. The Icemen needing to hold on to this lead. Atlanta in the slot. They cannot get the shot away. Hawerchuk drives it off the boards. Bernard holds it in at the left point. Playing it for Nesbitt. Centering feed. Sylvester curls in the corner. Feeds it to the blue line for Bernard. Cross ice, it's to Pottage. Playing it behind the net. Centering feed knocked away by Jacksonville. They'll play it out to center. Time continues to wind down. 1:15 to go in the contest. Jacksonville will steal at their own blue line. They'll loft it high into the air. Again, too soft for icing. And Jacksonville will change up their defensive unit. Atlanta clears back in. Final minute of play in period number three. The Icemen on top by one. Right circle, slap shot. Save is made, rebound right at the goal line, and the Icemen sweep it away and clear it out. It was Zach Berzola knocking it away from the blue paint. Crowd on their feet. 45 seconds to go. Atlanta clears in. Icing on Atlanta. Davison, no, it'll play on. I thought I heard a whistle. Yeah, we'll play on. Puck is behind the Jacksonville net. 34 seconds to go. Puck swept loose. It comes free to the Icemen. It's Nazarian who will dive and clear it out of the center ice. The Gladiators back in, delayed offside. The Icemen have the puck. It is wing to wing. Berzola with time in his own zone. To the opposite side, Lodermeyer deflecting it for Brown at the Atlanta blue line. 12 seconds to go. Jacksonville clears it in. This is going to be icing on Jacksonville. They didn't want that. Clock stops with 8.5 seconds to go.
Yeah, they didn't want that icing. They didn't need to do it either. Just a soft little chip off the boards. They would have angled deep into the zone and play would have stayed alive. And Atlanta would have had to go on the length of the ice with 8.5 seconds to go. So, again, that's one they'll look at in the game film. That's one of what not to do in that situation. But big time faceoff right now. I would expect we'd have some timeouts maybe even called here in this situation.
Atlanta now out shooting Jacksonville 27-24 overall. Out shooting the Icemen 14-2 in this third period. They've scored once, and the Icemen want to keep it that way. Jacksonville clinging to this 2-1 lead over Atlanta. The Gladiators do call timeout. Derek Nesbitt chirping at the linesman. Actually, no, it's the referee, Alex Normandin. Maybe for a penalty call, maybe for adding time to the clock. I'm not sure. Either way, the Icemen need their best face-off right now. One face-off win and a clear out without an icing will get the job done.
Yeah, it will. No, there's no doubt. So I would expect to see, well, again, I don't know because it was an icing coming off an icing whistle. I don't know who's out there for the face-off here. It'd be interesting to see. You know, I know the Icemen would love to probably have Derek Lodemeyer out there. He's been one of the key guys in those situations. But we'll see who the Icemen will have out there because, again, you can't, after the icing, you can't...
Lodermeyer is out there.
He is out there, so that's good for Jacksonville here for this draw.
It is on his opposite wing, I will say that. It's not his strong side, but he is Jacksonville's best face-off man. Just in case Christopher Brown is on the ice also, always responsible defensively, and he would be your second option if Lodermeyer happens to get waved out of the draw. Face-off to the right of Francois Brassard. Lodermeyer against Cody Sylvester waiting for the drop of the puck. 8.5 seconds to go. Jacksonville trying to survive this one and go up 3-0 in this best of 7 series. Ready to go for the drop of the puck from linesman Tanem Wyonzik. Lodermeyer wins it. It goes behind the net. Berzola is just pinning the puck up along the corner. Just trying to kill time away. Goes behind the net. 2 seconds, one. This one's over. And Jacksonville survives and wins it by a final of 2-1. Extracurriculars after the final horn. A couple of men go down. Tempers are flaring, but it's not going to take away the result. Jacksonville wins this one 2-1. They have a commanding 3-0 lead. Well, in this best of 7 series.
Well, we got an injury to the linesman right now who's down, and they're calling for the trainer, Jake Reardon, to tend to the linesman. But again, it's a situation here where the Icemen did an excellent job. First of all, Lodemeyer won that faceoff and got it in the corner, and then Zach Berzola, using that size and strength to his advantage, just tied the puck up. He grabbed it, pushed his stick with the puck against the boards and shielded it, and was going to make Atlanta take it from him, and that killed all the time off. It did come loose with about 1.5 seconds left, and Howarchuk was able to sling it around the corner. Time expired in Jacksonville now with a stranglehold on the series as they're up now 3-0, and will have an opportunity to close it out here in this building tomorrow night. It was scary. It came down. Another one-goal affair between these two teams, and hats off to Atlanta again for not going down without a fight. But Jacksonville getting it done, and Francois Brassard getting congratulations from his teammates. He was good here today. more than good. He was stellar. And with 27 saves here tonight, en route to the win. Three stars will come up here momentarily, but Jacksonville with a good hold right now, up 3-0 here in this best of seven series. Boy, was it scary coming down the stretch. Tell you what, this Iceman team, though, they don't like to do anything the easy way, and sometimes they don't like to help themselves out. Obviously, that icing whistle at the end that set up that face-off at the end, that did not need to happen. And then that was one of those situations, but what a great job by Lodemeyer to win that face-off. And then, of course, Berzola just taking the puck and cramming it into the corner and just hanging on to it for dear life to let the time click down. And Jacksonville getting this big victory here, and they're up 3-0 here in this best-of-seven series, and they'll have an opportunity to close it out tomorrow night here in this building. Get your tickets now, folks. It's an opportunity, and to see the Icemen try to win something of their first playoff series on home ice. We'll talk about it in a minute. Send it down to Joe for three stars.
From Atlanta, goaltender number 39, Chris Nell.
And Chris Nell was very good here tonight.
The number two star from your Jacksonville Icemen with a game-winning goal, number 22, Aaron Nazarian.
Aaron Nazarian had the game-winning goal, what would be the game-winning goal, but I'll tell you what, he made a lot of plays today. He was very active and certainly had Atlanta's attention and made some plays here in addition to that big-time goal that he had here tonight. He had four shots on goal, is the total they had up on the board.
And your number one star of the game with 27 saves. Oh, welcome back to Jacksonville, goaltender Francois Brassard.
Yeah, he was good tonight, wasn't he? And your ECHL goaltender of the year is your number one star here tonight, stopping 27 to 28 saves here in this game. And once again, be joined down on ice side with Arley.
Brass, congratulations. A chaotic third period. Atlanta swarming in front of you, but with the defense helping out and you keeping things so calm and collected, how are you able to do that and preserve this victory ultimately?
I think overall we did a great job in our defensive zone the whole game. I mean, we knew they were going to have a push in the third period, and we just had to, you know, play a solid 20 in our zone, try and get the puck out of our zone as quick as possible.
You now have a 3-0 lead in this best of seven series. Game four tomorrow night, right back here at home. How important is it to finish the job at home tomorrow?
Yeah, it'd be awesome to finish it at home in front of you guys tomorrow. Hopefully you guys bring the heat again.
What's been the key to these first three games? All 3 one-goal victories that's been able to help you get this lead.
Yeah, obviously it's a defensive end, right? It's being responsible and winning some defensive zone draws. And we've been playing really good in our defensive end, and it shows.
And you've been a huge part of it too, Brass. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.
All right, there's your star of the game, Francois Brassard. Joe, back to you.
Fans, there he goes.
And there you have it. Your number one star of the game goes to Francois Brassard, making 27 saves here tonight and some big ones down the stretch. The Icemen were outshot by Atlanta 15-2 in that third period of play. And Brassard stopped all of them but one. That was the goal by Holscher there on that turnover. Aside that, a perfect outing here for Brassard, who continues to keep the Icemen in these games. But what a big swing for the Icemen here tonight to get this win, because now it's up 3-0. I used the term stranglehold. That's exactly what it is, because if Atlanta wants to come victorious out of this series, well, they are going to have to do it in a way in which they're going to have to go four straight. Now, granted, they'll have some home games, 3 of them if they were to take it the distance, but they're going to have to win tomorrow, and the Icemen are going to try to close out this series. It would be their first series win here in their young 5-year history if they can pull it off, and you know they would love to do it in front of the home fans here tomorrow night. So we'll see how it plays out. 7 o'clock start time. Tickets available online at Ticketmaster.com. And go to JacksIceman.com or give our staff a call tomorrow, 904-602-7825. If you don't have a pin, it's pretty easy. 904-602-PUCK is the number to call. And the Icemen staff get you squared away with some tickets as well. But it should be a lot of fun tomorrow night, 7 o'clock. And not often you can see a team try to close out a series, and the Icemen have earned that opportunity tomorrow. But Atlanta will be fighting for their lives tomorrow night, no doubt about it. So again, the Icemen will have a little bit of a pushback to deal with, but Atlanta refusing to go away, especially late here in this game. Looking at the third period in the last two games, Atlanta has outshot the Icemen 31-6. Excuse me, that is that's impressive. And also a little alarming, if you ask me. I'll talk to Arlie about that fact here in just a second. But right now, a 2-1 victory here for Jacksonville. The Icemen getting on the board first, 3:13 into the contest on the power play, no less. And Jacksonville getting a goal from Luke Lynch, who was in front with the tip on the Brandon Fortunato shot. And that would make it 1-0. Christopher Brown in his return to the Icemen roster lineup. He got an assist on that goal. 1-0 Jacksonville. That score would hold into the second period until the 19:06 mark. Aaron Nazarian springboarding a chance and getting a goal for his first of the year. Great setup by Harris. And Fortunato, who had a pair of assists here tonight. And then, of course, the number. And then we go to the third period, and it was all Atlanta. They outshot Jacksonville 15-2. And Arlie, I was just saying, in the last two games, they've outshot Jacksonville in the third period 31-6.
Wow.
Unbelievable. I said, I don't really know what to think about that. That's more alarming and impressive from the Atlanta standpoint, but alarming from an Icemen standpoint. But hey, the Icemen held on. Broussard kept him in it. Holscher, though, would get a goal at 11-11. Sheen and Nesbitt factored in on that goal to make it interesting. And despite some scary moments and the Icemen not making it easy on themselves, they hold on for this 2-1 victory. And they have an opportunity tomorrow, Arlie, to close it out here on home ice. Before we get to that, Atlanta 0-2 on the power play. Jacksonville 1-5. Shots on goal, 28-24 in favor of Atlanta. Arlie, tomorrow is going to be very interesting.
Oh, this place will be absolutely rocking tomorrow. The Icemen with an opportunity to win their first playoff series in franchise history tomorrow, and they have the opportunity to do it on home ice, but it is their one and only opportunity to do it on home ice.
Yep.
So you better strike while the iron is hot, while you have the chance tomorrow evening, while Atlanta, I mean, they've got to be scratching their heads wondering, what do we need to do? You know, we continue to play very well, especially in the third period. We are finishing strong night and game after game after game, and we're still coming away with no results for our efforts. Great for Jacksonville. The Icemen are doing just enough. It's not like they're blowing Atlanta out of the water right now, but the Gladiators are a very good team. It's all about winning the game, whatever the score. In this case, it's 3-1 goal games, but the Icemen are doing just enough to get the victories. If they can do that one more time tomorrow night, it will be the Icemen moving on to the South Division Finals to face either the Greenville Swamp Rabbits or the Florida Everblades, which, by the way, they're in game three right now, and they are headed to overtime.
Wow.
In their game, 3-3 between Greenville and Florida. And that game, again, headed to overtime. But Jacksonville doesn't have to worry about that right now. They just need to take care of their own business that is here at home. Remember, a win here at home, and they sweep the series, and they will have roughly 8 days of rest before their next game. If you don't win tomorrow, however, it could be something entirely different. You have a trip to Atlanta. Atlanta feels good about themselves. Atlanta has up to 3 potential home games. They would, yeah, as we said late in the game, they would essentially wrestle home ice advantage away from Jacksonville,
yeah,
if they win tomorrow. So even though it's 3-0, do not take for granted that this series is over. It is far from over, especially as well as Atlanta has played late in hockey games. You know, if they have a breath of life going into 3 home games, even if they're down 3-1 in the series, if the Gladiators, yeah, happen to win tomorrow, yeah, if you're Jacksonville, you don't even want to think about that aspect. You want to finish it off tomorrow and get the job done.
Yeah, and, you know, that's the thing. They always say that the elimination game is the hardest win to get.
Yes.
Because, you know.
None harder than this one.
Yeah, and I agree. I mean, Atlanta is not going away. They haven't in any of the games. They've made it interesting down the stretch. Again, I love how Jacksonville played in the first two periods. Third periods, I don't know what's going on there. Atlanta's just kind of taking control, and it just seems like, you know, you have the seesaw, and it just seems like someone's just sitting at the bottom of the Icemen are, and it's slanted their way. But, hey, what are you going to do? You know, they got Broussard in there. He's getting the saves here in Jacksonville. They got it done, and that's the thing. You know, it wasn't pretty in the third period, but they found a way. Once again, they got it done, and they put themselves in position and a well-earned position to try to close it out in front of their home fans tomorrow, 7 o'clock. Should be fun.
Cannot wait, and I know this place will be buzzing. Get your tickets now, because if you want a good one, you better get them now, jacksicemen.com, for a potential series-clinching victory for the Icemen tomorrow evening. Last home game of this series for Jacksonville, no matter what, win or lose. So make sure you come on over here. You have a chance to see the first ever playoff series victory for the Icemen in their five-year history. That's 7 o'clock tomorrow. The Icemen lead this best-of-seven series 3-0, looking to finish it off against Atlanta tomorrow. That will do it for this one. Another great playoff game. Doing just enough for the Jacksonville Icemen to win their third consecutive one-goal game. And again, the Icemen come away with a 2-1 victory tonight. Thank you so much to Gemstone Media. We want to thank our off-ice crew led by Kate Truslow. And Alex, for you, this is Arlie Johnson saying goodnight. Things are looking awful good for the Icemen, but they are far from done with this series. But they do have a 3-0 series advantage over the Atlanta Gladiators with their 2-1 victory tonight. For everyone else involved, this is Arlie Johnson saying goodnight. What a wonderful night for hockey.